Sorry, a moment. Oh, pardon. I'm streaming. It is quite possible. We're gonna wait for the official notification, though, to see if I'm actually streaming. Jack begins! Great! Hi, everybody. Wait. Oh, and you know, when I'm here with Rich, usually I'm so on top of things as far as like updating the info and all that, the game we're playing. I didn't do that this time. You know why? Because I'm not on top of it. Oh, there's the email. Great. That was the email. Where's my face? My face is not here. I was trying to set up some sort of face cam for me in here, but the only camera I have is the one connected to my computer. I have the little, you know, eyesight camera. I need to raise my mic up. You just need to raise your volume up. We need to play Duskers. Oh, I want to play Duskers so bad. Should I start downloading Duskers so I can play more Duskers? I would love to do that. Hold on. I need to update the stream. The Flark. And the Flood. Sorry, everybody. Welcome. And now I'm mistyping. Because I'm trying to do it quickly. Update. Now we go. Hi, Solid Baked. Now, when is the clown coming in? I wanted to play Overwatch. Obviously, I've been playing Overwatch. You can turn the terrible music off if you want. You'll get used to it. I can turn it down a little bit. The music, you know, yeah, it grates on you a little bit. Here, I'll turn it down. It works well with the theme of the game, which is why I'm going to be okay with it. But no Overwatch tonight. I obviously have been playing a lot of Overwatch on my own because I'm really enjoying it. But for the stream, I won't be able to pay attention to your chat and play Overwatch. And I don't want you guys to make fun of me for being terrible, because I'm not that great yet. I'm only like 13 hours into Overwatch, and I love it. I love it so much. It's just so much fun to play. If you guys are a fan of Team Fortress 2, John Kilo subscribed for 25 months in a row. Jeebus H. Crisp, John Kilo, 25 months in a row. Thank you, John Kilo. John Kilo, one of our first mods, too, I want to say. I'm pouring a beer right now. Hold on. Everybody, please pause while I pour a beer for the Flame and the Flood. There we go. Old fogey. Pre-rec beer. No, pre-rec beer is not there. Or no, didn't I bring pre-rec beer back? I forget. Okay, so let's start playing a little bit of the Flame. Wow. Oh, did you guys hear that? I did pour that suspiciously close to the microphone. That's right, Sir Gimpy was our one and only mod for maybe a week. Octo J was first, really. I'm so sorry. It's obviously been 2 years since you guys have been with us, so I forget. Having a delicious hop freak from MKE Brewing, which is my beer of choice because it is 8.7% alcohol, so I can only have one of them and still, you know, get a little drunk, which is fun. Okay, so let's start a new campaign. This is the Flame and the Flood. I've beaten it already. I took some time and played this by myself, and oh, recommended for experienced player. Permadeath, fewer supplies, stats. Just you know what? I'm still gonna play it on easy. And I prefer Daisy. Daisy brings me luck, so we're gonna have Daisy. You can choose what kind of dog. I can drink. I'm at home. I'm at home, so I can have a beer. And TNG After Dark sent us a tip saying, "Hey, Jack, stoked for the solo stream. Get Overwatch. Got Overwatch based on your brief review, and am loving it. What are your favorite characters? P.S. Can you teach me how to properly use a pill?" Oh my god! All my achievements are finally popping. That's great. You guys might not be seeing that. There was a bug where none of my achievements were popping, and they are literally all popping right now. You guys can't see them because of the Steam overlay, but I'm getting like 20 million achievements popping at this exact moment. No, I don't know exactly how to use a pillow. I still haven't discovered how to use my pillow, but... Yay, achievements. What game is this? This is The Flame in the Flood. The Flame in the Flood. And what you play as is you play as this little girl. And this is a post-apocalyptic... post-apocalyptic world in which the world has flooded. And you have your dog here, Daisy, the Dalmatian, who's adorable. And you have to collect supplies. Here, we'll try to read all the stuff here. So these are your four stats. Hunger. Here, can I get my arrow? Yeah. Hunger, thirst, warmth, and exhaustion. You have to keep an eye on those stats. And then you get little things here. A feather, a sapling. And you gotta pick them up. And there's a crafting. Yes, this is a very Jack game. There's crafting involved, and you can shoo. Look, shoo. Shoo. Wait, where's that feather? Okay, wolf info. The black wolf. Later, as we get on, there are wolves. Spoogle, that was you who made the Big Dumb Hammer gift. Thank you for that. I thought that was adorable. I do love games with Big Dumb Hammers. Collect water. There's a whole bunch of stuff in this game. Yep, all this stuff. And then here's all the stuff we have, and then you can move stuff to your dog's bag ASAP, even though this is Daisy. And then when you're in the raft, you can move stuff to your raft. And then if you die, this is a procedurally generated roguelike. And so if you die, anything in your dog's bag sticks with you, which is really great. This is perfect for me to play. Yeah, it's kind of a survival game. Mostly because I can take breaks and chat with the chat while I'm playing this. Yep, okay, we know all that. So basically right now we're just collecting all the stuff. You get tasks, which is great. And the whole world has this kind of like creepy vibe to it. Okay, so here's our raft. It's our makeshift little raft, which is beautiful. Me and the dog get on it, and we're gonna go try to find our next dock. This is a relaxing and smooth game. I really enjoyed this game. It had some bugs for me. Like I said, you guys didn't see, but my achievements only popped when I played this game. And Rich Evans is on vacation. He is hanging out with Karen this weekend. This week, in fact. It's all this week. So it's just me this week. So here we have the other big part of the game, and it's just being on the raft in this flooded world, and we gotta find our next dock. And then when we go to the next dock, you pick up all the supplies and start crafting and start fighting enemies, and it's a crazy world, but I really dig the pace. It's very calm. It's very soothing. It's very desolate. And when you're playing a post-apocalyptic game, you want to feel alone. You get little rapids here. And you gotta... So all I'm doing right now is kind of like steering in the rapids. Ooh, see that thing? We gotta loot that. There we go. I got some salt. They have little things that you can loot if you can press the A button fast enough. I know. This song in particular, I hate it when they do vocals in any video game song. This sounds like the theme to Firefly, if you remember Firefly. Which is just has this like really cheesy country song. Okay, so now you might be seeing these orange circles. These are the possible docks. And right now, all I have is a rudder. I'm steering with my stick. So you can't hit every stop. So you have to choose. Like, I won't be able to hit both of these stops, so I'm going to choose these. Because I know campsites have a fire in them. The Firefly theme is not good. It's very cheesy. It's appropriate for Firefly. But it's very, very cheesy. You can't take the sky from me. I loved that theme, but it was incredibly, incredibly cheesy. Oh, here we go. Cattails. Cattails are super useful. That's going to get us some rope. That dog is good as dead in a game like this. No, I look after the dog. Empty house. That's fine. That's fine. So we go to every little dock and we loot all the things we can loot. Dandelions. You wouldn't think dandelions would be important until you need dandelions. Then they are the most important thing, as is anything in this game. So then here we'll go to our crafting menu here. Right now I can make braided cord, so I'm going to do that. Make some braided cord. Oh, I can make a stone knife. I should do that. Oh. Yeah, here's where it gets to be bullshit. And like, your bag starts off really, really light. Luckily, you can move stuff to Aesop. Move to Aesop. Or Daisy. Move it to Daisy. The art style of this game reminds me of the game Deathspank. Check it out. Ooh, maybe, yeah. I think I remember that. Oh, Deathspank. Wasn't that the that was the Diablo clone. That was a shooter, right? The shooter Diablo. I think I remember Deathspank. I think I remember liking it. Ooh, good. Here we go. Snare. You can't take this pie from me. Oh, okay, here we go. So, as you make stuff, as you craft stuff, right now I'm turning cattails, if you see here, I'm turning 4 cattails into braided cord. Now I can make a snare trap because later in the game there's rabbits. I can make a spear trap because later in the game there are wild boar that will attack you, or wolves. No, I'm not watching Game 2 of the NBA Finals. I do not care about sports. Okay, so I am actually going to make some of this stuff. I'm going to make a snare as long as I can. Oh, I need some more saplings now. And then there's certain stuff that you can only make if you're sitting at the fire. Right now I don't have anything, so it doesn't really matter. Do I have... I do have a jar. Okay. Here's the other neat thing. So, thirst. Thirst is something you have to pay attention to in this game. And you have a jar, and of course there's water everywhere. So I'm going to fill the jar here. Yes, there are wolves in this game. But, now I have a jar of polluted water. Luckily, I did get some water filters. So I can make clean water. Always have a jar of clean water with you. Okay. And so that's all I can get from that stuff. So now we jump back on the raft. I've heard really good things about Don't Starve. Never got around to playing it. I know there's Don't Starve Together now, which I think Rich and I should play. What about spikes? There are spikes in this game. There's actually a spike trap that you can make in this game to kill pigs. What? What is it, Daisy? To kill pigs and wolves. Which I may need to make. Ooh, good. I got some saplings here. Here's a church. Oh, good. Yeah, they got some stuff here. See if there's any rabbits we can hunt. Okay, so, oh yeah, I was gonna make a spear trap. Always good to have a spear trap handy. Water we can move to ASAP. ASAP. Aloe we can move to ASAP. Feathers we can move to ASAP. All the stuff you will need later. Everything is one of, you know, it's a roguelike, and so a lot of things you only find out when you die. You know, later on in the game there are snakes, and the only way to cure a snake bite is by making tea. And so in order to make tea, here we go, you need dandelions. You need dandelion tea. So there's usually nothing in the church. It is getting to be nighttime now, so... Dandelion tea, I know we need 4 dandelions and a jar of water, but I only have 1 jar right now, so that's pretty important. I'm not gonna... Jack, if I buy Don't Starve Together, will you play it with me and the chat? Maybe. Solid Bake, I do love bad bitches. That's my fucking problem. And yeah, I like to fuck. And it's a fucking problem. Ooh, I got a pouch. I got a pouch that adds inventory space. Ooh, that was a good get. Good get. Okay, great. Oh, so yeah, here's one other thing. So in my crafting now, I can make insulated boots, which is basically boots stuffed with cattails, because... As the game goes on, we move to colder and colder regions, and right now my body temperature is pretty good, but if it rains or if it gets cold, my body temperature is going to drop and I'm going to need better clothes. Tiberius Kirk, Downwell's fun. That's a fun little pick-me-up game. I know it just came out on the Vita, and I got it for my Vita, and that is just a beautiful handheld game. Perfect for handheld. Although lately, I just got down to played a little bit of it, but I've been picking up Crypt of the Necrodancer again. Maybe I can get over here. Yeah. You can kind of steer your raft. Okay, I missed that one, but I can get this one good. You can kind of steer your raft and then like shove it in a direction, which is helpful. When do you shoot demons in the fucking face? You cannot. Count Mippy. So the end goal, if you weren't here in the beginning, the beginning had this little cutscene in which the dog found us and gave us a backpack. And in the backpack was a radio. And so we have to find the radio signal. Basically find civilization. That's the goal of the game, is to find other people. And so we make it down the river, because that's the only direction we can go, in hopes of finding other people. Cattails. Cattails are good. They can make us warm clothes, but more importantly, they can make us rope. So we want all the cattails we can get our hands on. Because with rope, we get traps, we can make bow and arrow. Oh shit, so many cattails. Oh, nom 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 nom, all the cattails. And then kind of, oh yeah, splint, oh yeah. So like, you know, basically anytime you can make something you want to, like here's a splint. And if you get hit by a boar later on in the game, there's boars, it'll break your leg. And so you need a splint. So I'm just going to make one right now because I happen to have the materials to make one. I really have to question the idea of moving downstream in a cataclysmic flood. Yeah, but how else are you gonna move? You know? Oh shit, here's a boar, there's a boar. Run, 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 run. Run, 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 run. Run, 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 bun. Boar, 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 boar. Boar, boar, boar. Great. Oh, we're gonna fuck that boar up. You know why? I got a spear trap. I got a spike trap for that boar. This is gonna be great. This is gonna be fucking awesome. Where was that boar? Okay. So, got this spear trap. Lay a trap. Okay, now where were you, boar? Oh, there's a boar. Come on, boar. Right this way, this way, this way. Oh, you fucker. Did you see? He went around my fucking trap. Oh, ah. Gotcha. Oh, I gotcha. You son of a bitch. You know, I thought Duskers was the jackest game possible. I just found out I was wrong as fuck, right? There we go. So now we got some boar meat and a boar hide. So if there was a fire here, I could cook that meat. But before, we picked up that thing of salt. And so I'm able to make boar jerky. Which I'm going to do because eventually I'm going to get hungry. My hunger level is 69 out of 100. So... Hello! Oh, it is 3 a.m. in London. How terrible that you are watching, even though it's so late. Oh, sorry, and I've been missing tips. I don't have the tip thing on my computer, and I asked Rich to send it to me, and he didn't, because he's on vacation, and he doesn't care. Hold on for a second. Jack Skrillex ZipZap says, hey, Jack, just wondering if you got my DVD cover to sign. I sent it in over a month ago with return postage. Maybe... you all ignored it because it was a Star Wars cover. If it came in, I don't know. I don't check the mail. I just sign stuff when they tell me to sign it. I will ask next time I am in. I think I'm going to see them this week. So Jack Skrillex ZipZap, I will tell them. And from Gutter Stars, haven't tipped in a while. Thank you guys for the stream. Well, thank you, Gutter Stars, for watching. We really appreciate it. Okay, so I made some jerky. Which is awesome. And I also have some stitching kits here. I got really lucky early on, so I can make some boar hide stuff for when it gets colder. Let's see here. How about some boar hide pants? Yeah, some nice pants. Great. So then we take our pants, and we equip the pants. Equip pants! And then we take our old pants and we can make rags out of them. Because you could always use some nice rags. Boom. Alright, great. I am now tired, hungry, and thirsty, so I... Oh wait, first I'm gonna... What is this? Rags? Yeah, rags is good. What's over here? Sumac. I've never, ever used the sumac. Stitching... Oh great, more stitching kits. With sumac you can make like bombs, I think, and I've just never ever used it. Okay, I'm gonna sleep. Sleep for 4 hours. The joy of video games. I love them. Oh fuck, it's raining. Good thing I got them boar pants. Alright, now I'm gonna be hungry. Oh, this is great. This is actually super fantastic. So, it is raining right now. So we can take... We can take the water, and we can drink the water, and because it's raining, we can take the jar and fill it with clean water. Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that just beautiful? Isn't that just a fantastic way? We have some cattails and no braided cords, so we're gonna make some cords. There we go. Some board pants? I have some boar pants. And I'm... How much is this jerky filling up? 25? Yeah, I should eat that jerky. Great. Alright, so now I'm pretty good. Let's rock and roll. Yeah, exactly, leftover beefcake. Like, this game teaches you how to survive in the woods. You gotta kill a boar. You gotta, you know, bleed the boar. I think learning how to properly bleed an animal is a real life skill. Luckily, my time as a butcher taught me a little bit. I'm woefully out of practice, but it taught me a little bit how to properly bleed an animal. And you know, the thing is, when you, after you kill an animal, you want to get all of the blood out of it as soon as possible, because that's what makes the meat go bad. And you know, you want to get the pieces off and get the individual pieces off the animal as fast as possible to preserve the meat, is the idea. I'm sure that's exactly the kind of thing you wanted to... See, I can steer the boat a little bit. Where do I want to go? I want to go this way. I want to go this way. I can hit these two. Jack the Clown Butcher. I was a clown before I was a butcher. Which is still not a sentence that I think anyone wants to hear. Well, no, I was a clown before I was a butcher. See what happens? Like, I'm wet now because of the rain, and so that red ball is dropping because I'm cold. I could really use a fire. Crows are fairly useless in the beginning game. Crows make noise, and so crows will alert other animals of your presence. Oh no, I don't want to sleep. So if there is a boar or a wolf here, and it hears a crow call, it will come and get me. Use a jar. Yeah, I got some alcohol. Alcohol is good for making bandages. Ooh, some mulberries. Yucca. If there was a fire here. Regular yucca. Oh, no. Oh, damn it. Poison ivy. That's alright. Because I got this aloe. And aloe soothes poison ivy. But see, you have to watch out. This big patch of red here, that is poison ivy. I got distracted because of a devil's trumpet. This thing is awesome. This purple plant right here is one of the best plants in the game. Oh, inventory full. Hold on. Pause. Consume all of them. Mulberries. Do I have a hat on right now? I do have a hat on right now. So we can make rags out of this. Yeah, I got this alcohol. I'll move the alcohol. I can make a bunch of bandage. Actually, can I not make a bandage? Oh, I can. Great. Bandages are great for cuts. I'll move the bandage to ASAP. Okay, Devil's Trumpet. This thing is awesome. You can mix the Devil's Trumpet with raw meat and make tainted bait. And later in the game, you will consistently run into wolves. And so you can throw a piece of bait at them, they'll eat it and die. And it's great. It's great to kill wolves. I need some food, though. That's what I really need. Hey, Fake Plastic John. Welcome. Welcome to the Flame in the Flood. How are we doing here? Is there anything we can move to the rafts? Move the feathers to ASAP. The filters. We can move the filters to the raft. You know, raft has storage too, which is good, but you know, a lot of... Oh, raft-matic, obviously. We can move that to the raft. The sewing kits we can move to the raft. Let's move the splint to ASAP. Water we'll hold on to this. We can move to the raft. Rope we'll hold on to because we make stuff out of it. I should make another spear trap while I have the stuff. Hey, you and Rich were both butchers. You were literally hack frauds. Ha ha ha. So this is Firewatch with better-ish exploration and top-down view and no story. Well, no, no. Firewatch was, you know, was all exploration. This is a survival game. It's all about collecting resources, crafting those resources for to so you can use them for what you need. This is a survival game. Nothing like Firewatch. Firewatch was basically a story game with exploration bits. I liked them both, but very, very different games. This is not. Oh, wait, come on. Go, 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 go. Come on, get there. Got there. Got there. This doesn't have enough cutscenes, political dialogue, and love interests, right? That's it, John Kilo. Campfire plus woods automatically means Firewatch. It's interesting, because, you know, like, they have the... Ooh, good, more aloe. You always need to add out aloe. Oh, see, look at here. Fire ants. See these little red guys here? You always gotta pay attention to your surroundings. These fire ants will bite you, so you need aloe and shit. But I got some aloe now, so that's great. You know, it's nice, because there are certain things that you can only craft at the fire. So the fire is very important. And then, you know, there's only so much stuff you can store. And so you have to, you know, store stuff with ASAP. And store stuff on your raft. And so then you have to constantly, like, go back and forth over, like, who has what. Oh, I think I can make a stitching kit. Yeah, I can. Yeah, I can make a stitching kit. Shit, yeah. That's a raft. And so, you know, it's like resource management, inventory management, and survival. Basic survival. It's very basic. It's very basic survival, obviously, and I am playing on the easier mode, but I really like the easy mode. And the easy mode is still roguelike. So you only get one life to live, and then you gotta start your journey at the beginning again, besides what is in Daisy's bag. It's a very engaging game. These little floating down the river sections. Oh, fuck. See, and you crash like that. You can't really steer your raft. You can kind of push it. You have to actually follow these current lines. You can kind of steer your raft, but if you don't, you'll crash into shit and your raft has a health bar. Where am I going? One of those go-with-the-flow type situations. That's what this game is all about. Just, you know, take what life gives you, make the best out of it. You make some lemonade. Get good. I'm trying to get good. But I'm all wet. I think the game is about to get real. I think we're getting far enough now. Or we've hit up a couple spots where we're probably gonna run into a wolf soon. There's stuff to loot there, but I want to make it to this farmhouse. Farmhouses have corn. Farmstead, a source of wild food and clean water. That's important. Oh wait, it's raining. Oh, it's not really raining anymore. Well, shit. Added to my Steam Watch wish list. It's a fun one. If you're into that kind of stuff, I started playing this immediately after Doom, and it was ooh, rabbits, yes. It was exactly what I needed after Doom, where I just needed a slow game. A game that would let me take my time. Really, like, you know, stop and think about things. So, like, I started playing this in Duskers. Oh, shit, look at that. See that boar? He doesn't even know I'm here. That boar is gonna be so fucked. Build a trap for a boar. Okay, trap built. Hey, boar. Come on. Come on. Oh, I'm right here, boar. Come here. Oh, you're fucking dead, boar. Oh, good, yes. Oh, I'm hungry, though. I can make tainted meat, but I'm hungry. But I don't have a fire. All these things. I think I can eat dandelions. Can I eat dandelions? Well, I'm gonna. How about that? I'm gonna pick all these dandelions and I'm gonna eat them. I could really use some salt right about now. That's what I'm hoping for. I need some salt so I can eat some meat. Old, how about some old lumber? Well, that doesn't help at all. Okay, so there's rabbits here. And you see these rabbit holes. So we take our snare and we put it in front of a rabbit hole. Because now we're going to kill a rabbit. And then the rabbit's over here. We're going to scare him back to his hole. Go back to your hole, rabbit. Oh. Ah! Yeah, see, look at this. The game glitches sometimes. The rabbit's dangling over here. The snare is over here. It's got some bugs. But you know what? I still got a rabbit. So that's all I care about. So now we got a rabbit. Now we can skin the rabbit. Now I have two pieces of meat. So with one of them, I am going to make a tainted meat. Because that is a good weapon for later in the game. And actually, there's other rabbits here, so I might as well kill a few more rabbits. Spoogle, that's the thing. Spoogle says, I want to get into this game, but those eyes in that character portrait are doing something to my soul. Look at that. Look at your character portrait. That gives you a little indication of health, and you can see, like, some scratches on her face. She's something else. It's all part of. Wait till we. There are some NPCs in this game. Wait. Hopefully, we can meet some of them in stream, because they are creepy as fuck. Okay, let's catch another rabbit. Come on out of your hole, rabbit. Everything's fine. Come on out of your hole. Oh, gotcha. Just killing rabbits. I probably shouldn't enjoy that as much as I do. But, you know, what are you gonna do? The answer? Nothing. Now I have two pieces of raw meat. That only lasts 4 days. So I need a fire or I need some salt. But I got a boar hide. I got a rabbit hide. Ooh, I can make some more clothes. That's good too. And I'm gonna be hungry. I am gonna be hungry. I'm gonna drink some water because there's a water dealy right here. Fill my jar up. Great. I should sleep, but I don't have any food. Oh wait, no, can I eat dandelions? Have I discussed this already? Eh, I'm gonna eat them. I used to watch Man vs. Wild, Endercrom. I haven't had cable for a while. So I haven't, I hear Survivor Man is the superior one because he doesn't have a camera crew with him. My brother watches a bunch of other shows like Naked and Afraid. Those survival shows. You know. Man vs. Wild was alright. I'm gonna sleep for a little bit. Just a couple hours. Craft Tinder, then can. Oh, thank you, Fearful Sludge Boy. You are on top of it. If I craft a Tinder. I should be able to craft a campfire. Thank you, Fearful Sludge Boy. Now I can eat. So now I can take my campfire, build it. And now you can sit at your fire. Oh, look at that. Sit at the fire with your dog, and we can make some food. Oh, I have corn, that's right. So we can make some ash cake. Everybody loves ash cake. It's not true. We can make cooked meat. Cooked meat. I want to make dandelion tea. You know what? I might as well make dandelion tea. Right. Great. We are doing good now. Oh, now I can eat. I should eat, more importantly. Great. Great. Now see, look, now that I eat, look at the character portrait. She doesn't have the scars on her face. Her eyes aren't red anymore because we're a little healthier. And so there's that nice visual indication of when you are healthy. There are more rabbits here, but I guess we'll just keep pressing on. Or maybe I'll get, well, they're sleeping now, so they're not going to come out. No, you cannot customize her at all. And actually something that's a little upsetting, this game was kickstarted. It was a Kickstarter game, and I know it has a small dev team. I want to say the Halo, like some of the Halo team made this game, but I don't remember for sure. One of the really upsetting things about the game is part of the... What happened to my hat? Did I get rid of my hat? Part of the gameplay is equipping different clothes. And when you equip different clothes, it doesn't change your character model at all. And that's actually one of the most upsetting things. Is, I want stuff on my character to change too. Boarhide hat? Yes, let's make a hat. I made it into rags. I thought I got a second hat. Apparently not. Okay, now I have a hat. Now I have a boarhide hat, which is better, anyway. So oh, I can make some rabbit pelt gloves, too. I will do that. Alright, so now we will equip those. That will help with the cold. The website says that parts of the BioShock, Halo, and Guitar Hero teams contributed to this game. Thank you, Budget Messiah. So, you know, it is a kickstarted game. I know, like, it had a bunch of bugs. I ran into a particular bug where you have these two screens. You have the dock screen, and then, you know, you start the world screen. And I built a campfire right here. See bugs? Look, I can't walk here now. Because the game needs me to walk away a little bit. But I built a campfire right here next to the dock crossover screen, and my character glitched out and I wasn't able to leave the campfire. But even bugs aside, still a fine, fine game. Still a fine, fine game. Where am I going now? Yeah, and any of these that are just woods is always light on supplies and could potentially... I mean, any stop can have a wolf in it. And... Yeah, you know, we're just getting... And you can kind of, you know, you don't get to see very far, which... Get out of here, crow. Get! You know, which I like and don't like. Ooh, mulberries. Those are good. That's food and hydration. Eat those mulberries right away. Eat them mulberries. Move that piece up. Feathers are really only important for arrows later on. Oh, good. Here we go. Here's something interesting. Look at this thing. Every once in a while, you will run into these quilts. And here is the story of the game. Here's how the game handles the story. The quilt, a Big John Boar. Big John Boar kept his own counsel. Had his own opinions about things. The more facts presented proved contrary. The more facts presented proved contrary, the more he'd dig in deeper. That's what they want you to think, he'd fuss.
never rightly could say who they were supposed to be, but staying put just the same.
Well, that's how they handle the story of the game. And they have these quilts that kind of tell the stories of the townsfolk. Ooh, yeah, Devil's Trumpet. Get it while I can. Get it while I can. Anonymous, I see you, Tip Holland. Jack, would like to see you do a solo stream of a survival horror game someday. Evil Within, Silent Hill, or any of the old Resident Evil games. Also, me and my wife are big fans. Keep it up. Thank you, I will. You know, I don't play a ton of survival horror just because, I don't know, they're not that scary to me. But, you know, Halloween is right around the corner. We gotta do something for Halloween. Got these mailboxes, you get these tasks, which is always nice. Oh, watch out for prickers, pricker bushes. Okay, great, nothing else here. Nothing else here. Not, yeah, the survival horror just really isn't my type of thing. And I don't know. You know how you people get when Rich and I don't like the games that you guys like. And so I would hate to disappoint yet again. Always, just always. Remove the ash cakes to Aesop. Remove this to the raft. We can... Corn, I got that corn. I got that corn! And we can move that to the raft. Oh, this to the raft. Gotta make space in our own bag for when we're looting an area, but now we're, of course, the raft area is filling up. So that's the game. Managing supplies, alcohol, we can move to the raft. And aloe, we can move to Aesop. But it's not Aesop, it's Daisy. Part of the Kickstarter, I looked into this, because you can change your dog. I have this Dalmatian, which is Daisy. And that was a Kickstarter goal. Is if you donated enough, you could put your own dog in the game. The regular dog is Aesop. An older, like, a, he kind of looks like an old man. He has glasses. He's a cute dog, but I like Daisy better. I like Daisy the Dalmatian. The only problem is, you know, like, it's still called Aesop's Bag. Get over there. Got there. I don't think you've played the right survival horse. Maybe. That's true. Yeah, I try to stay. Is this a woods or a church? Oh, this was a fishing camp. Even better. Sapling, yes. Ooh, wild garlic, I can eat you. Hello, I will take sapling. You know, I'll just eat the dandelions. I'll just eat the dandelions. I don't need no more tea. Consume them. And the wild garlic we can consume. That's good food. That's good food right there. This game is pretty, Chernobyl Kinsman. I really enjoy it. Okay, great. So now we gotta loot. We gotta loot. Loot the room. Kick down the door, loot the room. Anyone who's played Munchkin knows what I'm talking about. You guys ever play that Munchkin game? That's a fun game. Some of the jokes I think they try a little too hard for, but still a fun game. I was playing some card games with my boys the other day. Oh, come on, get it. I wanna go this way. No. Oh, fuck. Wrong choice. See what happens when you try to turn away from the tide? My wife and I constantly try to prepare our boys to be gamers. And so, you know, getting them into board games is very important to us. And so she found recently a game called Sushi Go. Which, you know, like, I don't know if I'd ever play it with a group of adults, but for a kid's game, it's really fun. You have to kind of, like, You get a hand of sushis, of different sushis and sashimis and stuff, and they each have like modifiers that give you points, and you pick a card and then you give your hand to the next person, and then you get the hand from the person next to you, and then you pick another card and you try to make your best hand out of that. Really great for kids. Really great, just kind of learning. Ooh, another jar, yes! I needed another jar. Any two-player games I like to play with my wife? Legendary, Marvel Legendary works well two-player, and also Time Barons is a really good two-player deck-building game. We tried out the Adventure Time deck-building game, which is very fun. But it's like extra fun if you are into the series. And so I think I was a little more enamored with it than she was, but still fun. I should probably make some stuff. Get grubs. I'm gonna eat them grubs. I'm gonna eat them grubs. Ain't nothing wrong with eating a little grubs. What do I want to do here? Hold on. Before I loot everything, I need some more space. I have a deadly fart jar. Oh, there's a Munchkin Jr.? I did not know. That actually sounds great. Like, we started playing Catan Jr. with them. And, yeah, they were okay with that. It wasn't like perfect. Maybe a little too old for him, but Catan Jr. was pretty good. Keep that for this. We can move it to the left. Okay. But Sushi Go, they're really into that, and we got a Sleeping Princesses. Or Sleeping Queens is what it's called. Sleeping Queens, that's a fun one too. Really simple. Really simple card games, and fast, you know. Fast card games, which is really important when you have children. Oh, shit. Fucking yeah. We just hit the motherfucking jackpot. Pouches. Pouches add inventory spots. Shit. Fucking yeah. That's the mother load right there. We were handed this run 3 pouches. Oh, Sarachin, you need to try Catan. Catan will get you into these amazing board games. You know, we were always Monopoly people. We were always Risk people. You know, those are fine board games. They're fine basic board games. But then we discovered Catan and set off on a journey to find these amazing board games. There's, you know, this whole, like, hardcore board game community. Hold on. TNG After Dark says, are there any video games that you and your kids both play that they are legitimately better than you at? They recently got Minecraft, which, as anyone who's around kids know, that's crack for kids. And they're starting to build in Minecraft and make houses for themselves, and I barely know how to do anything in Minecraft, so... Oh, boar, 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 boar. Run away from the boar. Besides that, you know, like... I mean, they're still young, so not really. Do I have a... I don't have a trap. Can I make it? Oh, I can. I can make a spear trap. Monopoly... It's not perfect, but you have to play... Bork, bork, bork. You have to play by the actual rules. You can't have free parking. There are house rules that have slipped into the Monopoly lexicon that don't belong there. And so if you follow the actual rules of Monopoly, it's not that bad. Still not great. Oh, gotcha. Gotcha, bitch. Bitch-ass boar. Get out of here. So I like it. I like Monopoly. I ain't gonna hate. Here we go. Very important to taint the raw meat and not your cooked meat. That's, ooh, and another devil's trumpet, yes! Fuck, yes. We should sleep. We should sleep. Why can't you reuse traps? Because that's the game. because you can't. You would think that you'd be able to salvage something from it. You know, there's still rope and sticks, so you think you'd be able to salvage something, but you can't. Traps are one use items, which you just, you know, you kind of get used to. Yeah, I got everything from there already. Maybe because they're all covered in blood and that's gross. That's icky. You don't want to use them again because they're all icky. I just don't. I like Monopoly, but I can't play with people anymore. I become a cutthroat murderer of dreams. Yes, and that's, you know what, that's the other problem with Monopoly is it kind of relies on this barter program, and the way they balance the barter program later is just, it's very ruthless. And, you know, Catan also has a barter system, but it seems a little more balanced. The most important part of playing Monopoly, the way it's intended to be played, is putting properties up for auction when someone opts not to buy them. Yes, stick neutral. That is another rule that no one pays attention to. Oh, good. I can make some boar hide shit. What do I got here? Make some boar hide boots. That'll be good. Equip my boar hide boots. You do not have to dig a hole and poop in it in this game, though I think I would enjoy that more. That would be funny. Alright, we can turn light boots into rags, which is totally a normal thing. Just turn your boots into rags. That's totally normal. Because I have my boar hide roots. That's a rule. If someone lands on a property and they opt not to buy it, that property goes up for auction, that and other players get to bid on that property. Highest price wins. Free parking, you know, everyone uses as a monopoly. They you know, anything paid like to the bank or property taxes or anything like that goes into free parking, and then you land on free parking, you get that. That's the lottery, and that's not a real rule. And that extends the game. Like, there's a bunch of things that make the game longer, and that's why everyone hates Monopoly. And I don't think there should be as much Monopoly hate as there is. Fine game. You should totally play Minecraft with your kids on stream. I mean, they're, like I said, they're into Minecraft, and they love, you know, it's digital Legos. They just love building shit. I'm not into it. I'm gonna drink some water here really quick, as long as it's raining, and fill my water jar back up with clean water. I always love in Monopoly, I always love the purples, the first two, Beloit and Mediterranean, like the two cheapos. I get full hotels on them as soon as I can, and I'm the slumlord. As soon as people pass, go, they have to give me all their money when they land on them. It's great. Mulberries, I love mulberries. Sumac, I never use you. Gotta watch out, there's pricker bushes over here. What's the other rule? Oh, you know what the other rule that everyone forgets is, I just had it. Houses and hotels. You know, every property you can put four houses on, and after you put four houses on, you're able to put a hotel on. Get out of here. But usually what happens is once... once people run out of houses, they just like make makeshift houses and say, oh, well, you know, this quarter is a house, this fingernail clipping is a house. And that's not the official rules. The official rules is once you run out of houses, no one can build a house. And so there's a legitimate strategy there where if you have four houses, maybe you don't want to upgrade to a hotel to keep other people from putting houses on their properties. But, you know, that's another, like, house rule that got thrown out that extends the game. Have I been playing this long enough to say whether or not it's worth it? Oh, yeah, R. Miller. Actually, I've already beaten this game. I played this on my own after Doom, after I got the Doom review out, and I love it. I really enjoy it. It's kind of a lighter-toned survival game, and... Nightcrawlers. Yeah, might as well. So I actually really enjoy this game. Yes, I highly recommend this game. It is, like I said, it is a lighter survival game, but it's also like it's procedurally generated. It's roguelike, where once you die, you have to start at the beginning, and then every little dock you hit afterwards will be different. Oh no, that looks right. The only thing that carries over is what's in Aesop's bag. This stuff, if you die, your dog finds you again and gives you a backpack again, and all this stuff that's in your dog's backpack makes it back to you. So, you can't fish in this game, Dreamer TK. Well, or maybe you can. I have not found a way to fish in this game, even though you get fishing line and you can get fishing hooks and you can get night crawlers. I was not able to fish in this game. How long did it take me to beat it? I don't know. How many hours do I have in it? Well, let me shift tab. I have 18 hours into the game total. But that includes, you know, the couple of hours I've been playing now. So I'd say maybe 15, 16 hours it took me to beat total. So. But you can, you know, like it has an endless mode. It has many ways to replay the game, which I really like. Poor Aesop stuck in an endless cycle of watching his best friends die, right? $20. Is it the game $20? I don't know. I enjoyed it. I had a great time. $20 for 18 hours. That's what I've gotten out of it so far. And this run, too, I'm enjoying. And I am, again, I am playing kind of on the easier difficulty just because I find it very relaxing. Very light survival game. It does have a bit of an annoying... Oh, I don't think I can hit. I don't think I can get over there. See that guy? I can't get over there. Later, you can get an upgrade for your raft where you can get an engine on it. I personally think that $20 is totally worth it. I could see someone easily getting 20 to 30 hours out of this game. And it has replayability. So... It's an endorsement from me. Obviously, you're seeing it. Like, you know what it is here. It was such a nice game, kind of mid-Doom edit. I'd be editing the Doom and need, like, an hour break while I was rendering stuff. So I just picked this up for an hour, go to a couple docks. So it was a really nice pickup for a short session game for me. And coming off of Doom, I needed a bit of a break. Okay, so here we have a marina, which is a little bit different. We can get upgrades to our raft. Our schematic raft hardware. Maybe I want a rudder or a sturdy frame. Alright, so I have a bunch of wood and shit in my raft. Oh, no, damn it. I still don't have the controls quite down. As you just see, I left and now I can't go back. You cannot go back to a dock once you left it. And what I wanted to do was craft some stuff in my backpack and put a rudder on my raft, or maybe build a better frame for it, but instead I hopped on my raft and that fucked me. Because who knows when I'm going to come across another raft fixing station. Yeah, this is PC only, as far as I know. Chat, can you double check on that? The flame and the flood, I believe this is PC only. I'm playing on the PC. Are you playing this on your iMac? I think I have the same machine as you, but I don't know if... Yes, I'm playing this on my old iMac. I played on the Mac side. This I'm playing on the Windows side just because I'm streaming and I needed the Windows side for OBS to work. But it works on both Mac and Windows. I can fully attest to that. Need a little more story here. Yeah, to be careful. Could be a boar around. Xbox One as well. Oh, is it on the Xbox One as well? Oh, well, then there you go. Xbox One and Mac OS and Windows. Well, obviously. Thank you. Thank you, chat. The quilt of Hooper Farms.
Not for me, Hooper Harms told each passerby right proudly. Ain't some leftover to be put in the fridge. Any concerned about Hooper's intentions didn't let it show. Town folk had heard him spout his notions on random topics just about each moment of every day. From the look on the pilgrims' faces, the quiet of space seemed like a blessing.
Windows 7. Yeah, I dual boot my iMac with Windows 7, which you can do on all Macs. With Bootcamp, as long as you have a legitimate copy of Windows, you can dual boot, you know, which I do for games and for other programs that I need to run on the Windows side. So I have a partitioned hard drive. So I can make it a Windows machine or a Mac machine. What's that? Yucca?
Yucca? I don't need no yucca.
I like that, Dick Neutral.
Hey, kids, want to play a game where you look for corn and quilts? Well, you got to try the flame and the flood. Do you want non-confrontational combat and eating corn cakes? Well, get your ass to the flame and the flood. Out now on the Xbox One.
Bootcamp, yep. Bootcamp comes standard with all Macs. And it's great. It's great, you know, because there are some programs that will only work on a Windows machine. Why don't we sleep for a bit? Just a few hours. Get some shut-eye.
High stakes, sudden death quilting. Hunger coming at you.
Godem.
What?
Godem Ponerd says, ever tried the miniature games? Mage Knight, Hero Clicks, the X-Wing Tactical Space Battles? No, I have not. I don't even know what those are, and I'm very sorry.
I'm gonna eat some dandelions.
That's what my plan is. Ooh, I got mulberries too, that's right.
Eat some dandelions, chew on some mulberries.
What? Marco's Pizza. They're like Warhammer Lite. Oh, you know, I've never played Warhammer either.
There's a lot of games I never played. Too many games. Not enough time. Mm-hmm. Gum. Mm-hmm. Nope, can't make it to that one. Shit, can't make it to that one. That's alright, just keep on keeping on. Yes. I will take that salt. Shit. Shit. Shit, shit, shit. Nice dodge. Did you see that dodge? I was so fucking on top of it. I might be making the rafting look a little too easy. This raft handles like absolute balls, as it's supposed to. It's designed to handle like balls. My name is Tate, I agree. The art style is wonderful. Just, you know, cartoony, but just the right amount of creepy. It's really off-putting in the correct way. Wait till you see the wolves. They're great. They are just great. Yeah. Handling balls. Have I patronized a food? I haven't patronized any food truck recently, so no. There are, you know, in my neighborhood, there actually are surprisingly few food trucks. And we are a restaurant-y neighborhood. Maybe that's actually why there's surprisingly few food trucks. Oh, can I make it to this one? Nice. Oh, has it been an hour? Okay. If it's been an hour, let's stand up, everybody. It's been about an hour. Let's just stand up for a moment. I don't have my stand-up timer on because I'm terrible.
Stand up.
Thank you, Dreamer TK, for reminding me to stand up. A friend of ours says he saw you in Toronto. Is that true? No, I have not been to Toronto recently. Okay, and I'm going to start the stand-up timer, too. I just stood up. Oh, it's actually 10 o'clock on the dot, so that's great. But I'm still going to start the stand-up timer. 1 hour. Boom. Start. Great. Got it. The guitar is getting on your nerves. It sounds like a douche constantly strumming on a guitar. I can't agree with that. It works well with the theme of the game. It's very backwater country rambling, so I get it. 2 years no sigs for me. Congratulations, Captain James May. Life-changing. Okay, we are now getting to the more populated regions. And I might just be knocking on wood here, but we have yet to run into a wolf yet. And that really concerns me. Because you just think we would have run into one by now. Right. Just in case, actually, I'm going to build a spear trap. Because we should. Cord. We're gonna be prepared. We're gonna try to be prepared for anything. Usually you can search these cars. Yep. Got some bolts, great. Sometimes you can search these things. Do you see that little pulse under the door? There's that like wavy pulse. That means you can search that area. Hungry. I see that I'm hungry. I'm gonna work on that, and actually I think I have some meat.
I think I have meat to eat.
I do.
Consume.
What's it like giving up cigarettes? For me, it wasn't that bad. It was a long time ago since I smoked. And you know, you want you want them, is the simple way to put it. You really, really want them, and you know they're bad for you, and you know they are killing you slowly. Okay, like I'll take that. And yet you still really want them. Even though you know that you smell bad when you go out. And you know that it costs you a ridiculous amount of money. You can know all of these things, yet you still, your body craves them. Because that's, you know, what drugs do. So, just kind of weird. Oh, I think there's an NPC here. Ooh, yeah. There's a creepy NPC here. Let's visit Magnolia. Look at that. Need some grub, stranger? Got some rabbit left? Already ate my fill. Ain't always so nice. But I had me this dream the other night. Saw my mama clear as day, young and fair. Told me I ought to be more avuncular and magnificent. Already done broke bread with you. Want I should share some learning? Sure. You get snake bit, brew up some dandelion tea. Sumac's tea best for stomach bugs. Them plants got magnesium in them. Finest thing. Yep. Ain't nothing to it. I'll see you later. Ooh, water. Yay, it's raining. Yay, it's raining. Do I have a rabbit? Oh, I do have a rabbit in my... I do got me one of them rabbits. Oh, she gave me the rabbit. I'm paying attention. I'm totally paying attention. Okay, so much like the fire... Here is a workbench, and there is certain things that you can only build at a workbench, like a metal hammer. Boom. Now we got ourselves a metal hammer. And I think we can build a knife here. Once we have a steel knife, we can start building a bow and arrow and shit. I need a boar hide and nuts and bolts. Oh, I think I have a boar hide in the raft. Great. Great, great, great. I'm gonna go get my boar hide. And see, here's the other, like, kind of bullshit part of the game, where you don't have a ton of storage on you, so you put stuff on the raft, but you can only make stuff at the workbench. Oh, I need a boar hide, so I gotta run all the way back to the raft, grab my boar hide, run all the way back to the bench, making sure I remember, don't get on the raft, get your boar hide. Making sure you remember what it was that you were going for in the first place. Raft. Oh, I can make jerky. Yeah, make jerky. So, like, there are some mildly... Nuts and bolts. Oh, I need more nuts and bolts. Moved bag and... Oh, did I? Oh, fuck. I used my boar hide. Oh, well, shit. You need a teleporter. You know, it's just, it's one of those things where I get it that they want to make this work shot, or, you know, this workbench an important landmark. But it's just a lot of running back and forth. I used my boar hide because I'm a big dumb dummy. Big dumb dummy. I didn't know I was so close to workbenches. That was my problem. I didn't know I was so close to a workbench. Motherfuck. Motherfuck. Fuck. Motherfuck. What I got here? Saints of bait. Spear trap. Oh, there's no boar. Well, maybe there's a boar on the island. Maybe there's a boar here. Maybe there's a boar here. Yes, that's you. Maybe I just missed the boar. Rip up boots? I'm not gonna rip up my boots. I learned my lesson. I'm already starting to get cold. I have rabbits. Rabbit pelts. I'll take you. Is the boar sleeping? And, you know, some of the crafting doesn't really make sense. Like here, I need a boar hide and some nuts, and then I can craft a steel knife. Well, that doesn't make a ton of sense. Rabbits. We got rabbits here. Alcohol. I need no alcohol. Salt. Could definitely use that. And alcohol. Well, shit. Ain't got no boar here. I got a hammer, though. Got me a metal hammer. Yeah, my character is now looking a little ragged because our temperature is dropping and we're getting tired. We'll see if we can make it to one more place before I need to stop. What's with her demon eyes? As your stats start to drop, her demon eyes become more and more pronounced as a visual representation of her declining health. And as you guys are listening to this song right here, a gentle reminder to all game developers. Oh, shit, shit, wolf. Wolf, wolf, you see? Ah, fuck, 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 three wolves. Look at that. Look at them. Look at them wolves. They don't cross a line. There's an invisible line that they do not cross. But look at those fuckers. Three of them. Son of a bitch. I can get right up to him here. There's an invisible line where they will not cross. Actually, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to kill them all. Here. Eat that, wolf. You jerk. How about you? Go ahead. Yeah, go ahead. Eat that. So now... Oh, yeah, dead. And number two is... Eat my bait. Did you not die? Did you not die, you son of a bitch, wolf? Why did you not die? Look at that bait. Eat it. Did you not eat it because you saw your friend die? Eat my fucking bait. Alright, fine. Well, I think I can get away with like laying a spear trap here. I don't know if this will work. We're gonna see. Splinter shield. Ah, gotcha. Yeah, gotcha, you son of a bitch. There, grab my tainted bait. Also, obviously, as you can see, this game is ripe for the cheesing. There, you eat it. Yeah, there you go. Killed all three of them. Ripe for the cheesing. As you see, I'm cheesing the fuck out of it. Alright, great. Now we got three dead wolves. Oh, ripe, right for the cheese. It is, like, especially there. But obviously, like, I needed all of those supplies in order to properly cheese it. So, like, there's a little bit of skill involved as I was readily prepared for all of those wolves. But because I was readily prepared for them, I was able to... Oh, fuck, fuck, boar, 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 run, 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 boar, boar, boar. Wolves and a boar. Yeah, get out of here, boar. Now I need to build another fucking trap. The cheesening, yes. That's exact. Oh, good, I can. Yes, this is the in-game music, which, yes... gets a little much, I guess is the polite way to put it. Attention, video game developers, please do not have people sing in your in-game music. It takes you right out. It takes you right out of the game when people sing in your video game music. Eat some garlic, eat some mulberries. Like, a lot of the music really works. The acoustic guitar stuff works really well, but then every once in a while, he'll go into an actual song. Alright, let's lay down a trap here. Just don't use words. Right, yeah, just don't have someone singing actual words. Alright, where was that boar now? Oh, there he is. Hey, boar. Hey, boar. Hey, boar. Come on, come here, come here. Come here, boar. Come here, boar. Gotcha. Great. So now I have a boar hide. So now, if I run into a workbench again, I can make a knife. Another jar. I don't need another jar. I'm going to leave that jar. I already have too many jars. Discard. Discard jar. Boom. Dandelions, we don't need no fucking dandelions. I got plenty of water. Dandelions, dandelions. Here you have some asshole singing while you murder animals. Yeah, yeah, it's really out of place. Like, sometimes if the song starts and you're, like, going down the river, it kind of works. But here when you're, you know... surviving and crafting items and running away from wolves for dear life, and that guy is singing. It just takes you right out of the mood. All right, great. We are doing. Oh, I need to sleep. But I can't run into the ants. I see all these ants here. Woo. Am I gonna get bit by an ant? No. Oh fuck, I am. Fuck, fuck, fuck. Bit by fucking ants. And now I got... Wait, what do I have? Ant stings. Aesop has aloe, yes. Great. And so when you get stuff like that... You know, I had ant stings. Like, right now I'm wet. When you have afflictions, your stats drop quicker. And so you have to be very careful when you have an affliction. Except Lady Tita. You're right, the master. Lady Tita is obviously the exception. That music belongs anywhere at any time. What was that? Sumac. I don't give no fucks about no sumac. Might as well drink some water as long as I'm here. And there's water. Just to top me off. And I munch on some dandelions. Because why not? Because I got dandelions. Might as well munch on them. Oh no! Save the boar hide. But I do have wolf shit now, which is great. I need some rabbits. I have wolf stuff now, so now I can start making wolf. Look at them! Look at the three dead wolves. So now I can start making wolf hide clothing, which is really awesome. Alright, off we go. Oh, oh, no. This way. This way.
This way. Yo.
There we go. Wolf it up. But I believe to make wolf hide clothing, I need leather kits, which means I need more rabbit hides. Which is fine. Catch the rabbits. We can catch the rabbits. See, like here, you get like that, you know, soothing acoustic bullshit. There we go. Ooh, nice find. Anything glowing, you gotta loot. Free shit, and I got some jerky. I'll take some jerky. You get a guy singing while they're going down the river. Yeah, that's acceptable. Rich, yes, Rich is on vacation. Rich is taking the week off. So you're gonna get today and fuck. And more wolves. Is it just one? Fuck you. You know what? I can deal with just one. Well. Oh, nope. There we go. There's more. It's gonna be three of them again. Look at these fuckers. Don't they look mean? I love it. Look at them. Oh, he's presenting. They cannot hurt your dog. Oh, man, he's creepy looking. He is just creepy looking. I don't want to deal with more wolves. I'm getting out of here. And wolves do come out at night. During the day, you can sneak up on them and they'll be sleeping. Make a torch. The wolves look unhealthy. Surprisingly, they are still alive. Well, yeah, there's rabbits. There's rabbits to eat. Taking it easy. We're taking it slow. A bunch of cattails here, so we want all these motherfuckers. I think there's a workbench here. I think they said that there's a workbench here, so we want to... I don't need any of that. I don't need any of that right now. Torches fend off wolves. Oh. Just fend off wolves. Really? Okay. Lumber. Yeah, I'll take some old lumber. Jerky. Boom. Killing it. I really thought there was going to be a workbench here. Maybe I was just hoping. Just hoping there's a workbench here. Alcohol. I just don't need alcohol at the moment. I'm Jar Jar? Speaking of don't need alcohol, I needed a refreshing glass of beer. An entire glass. Maybe I missed it. Did I miss the workbench? That would be great. I would love a workbench. Ooh, sapling. Sapling? Motherfucker. Nope. Alright. Yeah, maybe Wednesday we could do a board game. We could do a couple two-player board games with me and Lisa. I will talk to her about it. We will see. I haven't decided yet. I have not decided what I wanted to do on Wednesday. Hadn't given it much thought. Oh, we have so many cattails now. Why didn't I take everything from the car in the chest? Because it was jars and alcohol. And so, you know, I have limited inventory room in my backpack and on my raft. And I already have an extra jar. And I have a jar full of water. And I have a jar full of dandelion tea. So I don't need any more jars. I also have now 5 bottles of alcohol. So I don't need any more alcohol. And that's all that was in there, was jars and alcohol. So I just didn't need it. So, okay, we can move to raft. Wolfhide, we can move to raft. Boarhide, move to raft. Okay, I'm going to discard the right, because I already have 10 of them up here. Inventory management is a big part of the game. So right now I'm like optimizing, so you can only hold 10. So I got 10 cords. Now 10 saplings and 10 saplings, and I'm actually probably going to get rid of these 2 saplings just because it takes up... Well, I can consume them, sure. It just takes up space in my backpack, and space, and I need space. I'm gonna drink the water as long as it's raining, because that's what you do when it's raining. And then fill up the jar. Is there any salt? Can I make jerky? Now that I'm thinking about it, can I make jerky? Do I have a stone hammer? Ooh, I don't have a stone hammer. I can make a stone hammer. I don't know why I need a stone hammer, but I'm gonna make one. So you make tools, and... I can't make another stone hammer. Nothing. Nothing that I couldn't make before. Oh well, doesn't matter. Another spear trap, just in case. Make a noose? Okay, I'll make a noose. A rabbit noose? Shit, yeah. Great. And away we go. This for PS4. No, Stealth Quarantine Ninja. Stealth the Quan 9 Ninja. This is for Mac, PC, and Xbox One. I'm currently playing it on the PC. I've also played the Mac version, which works ish. It has some bugs, but it's still very good. Still very good. Alright, I need to hold on to 3. Hold on to at least 3 nuts and bolts to make my knife. And I only have 4 nuts and bolts? Is that what you're telling me, game? I believe if I make a rudder, if I make a hardware, but then I need to use my nuts and bolts, and I really want that knife, because if I have a knife, I can make a bow and arrows. Which would be exceedingly helpful. But you can make all sorts of upgrades for your raft. You can make a water purifier, more raft storage, a raft shelter, which is very convenient, a stove, which is great, a sturdy frame, lots of stuff for your raft. Actually, I'm probably just going to do some moderate repairs. Is there any sound to the game? You should be hearing soft wave noises. Some soft wavy type noises is what you should be hearing. I need more raft storage. That is my big goal at the moment. Okay, so we need a workbench. That's what our goal is right now. We need a dock with a workbench. Fuck. Okay, great. Oh, can't make it to that one. Did someone say synthwave? No, we can't have a synthwave soundtrack to the Flame and the Flood. That would completely ruin the mood. Krieger783 says, Duskers is great, but not to watch. I can totally see that. I am in love with Duskers. Duskers is a game that I feel like people really should play because it's so unique. But I could see it not being that much fun to watch. I'm really glad you guys indulged me. Indulged me that week. But I probably won't be playing any Duskers. Maybe I'll be playing some Duskers. Because I really like Duskers. Alright, just going for some light supply hunting here. That's a bolt. Oh, there we go. That's helpful. Saplings are always useful for traps. Flint is always useful. I don't care about the crows at the moment. Stitching kit. Mulberry, mulberry. Mulberry, mulberry. Mulberry. Mulberries are great because they cure hunger and hydration, which are two things I'm going to have to deal with soon. How many cattails do I have? Do I not? Where do I? Oh, cat. I have 10. I have 20 cattails and only 5 strings. Ripcord uses 1 cattail. So I can take 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Turn those into 11. 2. 3, 4, 5. Now I have 10 braided cords and 20 cattails in case I need more braided cords. And saplings, we're good. Might as well need all these. When you're looking in your inventory, the game is not paused. You can pause the game in this menu. But when you are crafting stuff, when you are looking in your inventory, no, the game is not paused. There is this quick selection menu here. You know, like if you need to eat something or drink your water really quick, or if you need to lay a trap or anything really quick. But yeah, the game really wants to kill you. Oh, here we go. Oh, so one of the tasks that I got was to craft the simple tools, which I did. And so it gives me a little treat. Campfire. Oh, and that actually completed another goal. A fucking jar. I don't need a jar. Just don't need a jar. Dandelion. Take all the dandelions and I'm going to eat them. Sapling. Alright, let's eat all the dandelions. I don't know if you... Oh shit, wolves. Wolves, 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 wolves. Running, 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 wolves, 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 running. Fuck. Wolves come out at night. Fuck. That was a close one. I know, I need a torch. Don't take the jar. No, I'm not taking the jar. I have a jar of water already. I have a jar of dandelion tea, and I have an empty jar just waiting for something. I don't need another jar. I need a workbench. The wolves come out at night. The wolves come out at night. Should make another spear trap, just because I have all the stuff. Okay. I believe one of these next stops is a workbench so I can make a proper knife. Yeah, that one with the hammer on it probably has a workbench. Or is it this one? No, it's the hammer. It's the hammer.
Oh, I probably could have made it to both.
You gotta choose. Kill wolf and eat it. Pack the leftovers in a jar. If only... See, he's singing again. The motherfucker is singing again. Do you hear this? Are there gonna be wolves here now too? I'm gonna have to fight wolves while I listen to this motherfucker sing? Are there... Yep, there's wolf. There's wolf. The cutoff. Where does he stop following me? Right here? Yep. Okay. There. So I'm gonna cheese it again and throw my tainted bait at him. And I'm gonna kill him. Option sound music off. I could do that. Some of the music I really enjoy though. The instrumental stuff I really enjoy. We got a dead wolf. Dead wolf. So in here, yes, a devil's trumpet. Use a tainted meat. Get a tainted meat. Boom. Later in the game, devil's trumpets become a little more rare. And they're just so, so useful for killing wolves. What is that? What is that? Fuck, 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 fuck. Boar, 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 boar. God damn you, boar. You do get a little fast run if you hold down the right bumper. And then you see that, like, blue line in front of me? That's my stamina. So you can run fast in short bursts. Kill this stupid boar before I can make my knife out of the boar skin. No, and you know what? Hunchback Jack, the singing is not bad. The songs. Where are you now? There. The songs are not bad. It's just like right now I'm running for my life from a boar. And now I have a bloody boar carcass in front of me that I'm carving up for meat and hide. And it's just, it doesn't always fit thematically. I think they should save the singing for when you're on the river. And then cut to non-singing music. John. When you are off. Okay. Now I got a workbench, so now I can make a steel knife. So now, I have all my tools. Stone knife, stone hammer, steel knife, metal hammer. So now I can make some shit. So now I need some feathers. Can I make a bow yet? Yes, I can make a bow. Totally gonna make a bow. Shit, yeah. My jacket. I'm gonna make a boar hide jacket. Can I do that? No. Boarhide gloves. And I'm not that cold. And I'm gonna sleep, actually. I'm gonna sleep for a little bit. They should save the singing for not this game. It's no, it's fine. It's fine. Just, you know, not when a boar is chasing me. Save it. Save it for when you're on the river. That's kind of a more light-hearted adventuring setting, you know. Nuts and bolts, that's fine. We can use nuts and bolts. Dead wolf. Dandelions. Eh, you know what? I might as well take all these dandelions and eat them. Maybe they have rabbits here. I'm gonna wanna stick around and hunt some rabbits. I do, in fact, want to stick around and hunt some rabbits. Doop doo doop doo doo. Fill jar. I'm sorry, you cannot fill the jar with urine. I would love to fill the jar with urine. I'm unable to. While we wait to catch a rabbit, get some dandelions. I should make some arrows too. Rabbit. I should go make some arrows. We can hunt rabbits with arrows. It's way. It costs less supplies to kill a rabbit with an arrow. It's a little bit harder to hit the rabbit. Oh, I almost fell. Can you fall off? No, you cannot fall off. Rabbit. Great. Can I not make arrows yet? Where are my arrows at? From the front to back. Yeah, I can. I can make one arrow. Well, I will take it. That's fine. That is fine. I don't make a boarhide jacket yet. So I could make a pouch, which will give me extra carrying capacity. One more pouch and I'm full, but I need rabbit pelts to build a leather. Move my stitching kit to my bag and move my rabbit pelts to my bag. And I think that's it. Hold on. Is it the green arrow? If I remember correctly, with a workbench I can make leather kits. And with that I can make wolf clothing. Yes. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Now we are taken care of. Now I can make a wolf hide jacket. Shit yeah. Oh, I can even make a wolf hide hat? Motherfucker. How about wolf hide gloves? Yeah. Shit yeah, we are in it now. Can you just accumulate as much stuff as you want? Colonel Roach Mustard, no! Here is my backpack. Right now my backpack has 24 inventory slots, so I can only hold 24 items. Here's all the stuff I'm holding, and here's like the two free spots if I come across anything else cool. So I can hold 24 things. Aesop can hold 6 things. And my raft currently can hold 12 things. So, but you know, as you see here, like, for example, stuff like cattails, I can hold 10 in one slot. I can hold 10 saplings in one spot. So, like, there's a little wiggle room, but you do, you know, inventory management is a big part of the game. But, wait, what are we doing? Okay, equip the wolfhide gloves. Go. And equip the wolfhide jacket. That will keep us warm as shit. Awesome. Turn this into rags. And turn this into rags. Also, there's really no reason to do that because I already have 10 rags. Can I make bandages? Maybe. I think there's alcohol in the thing. All right, great. Well, hey. We're on it now. We are on top of things now. Maybe I'm gonna kill one more rabbit if I can. Oh. Dead rabbit. Just because I could, I killed a rabbit. Just because I want to see if I have enough to make another leather kit. Leather kits are pretty important for making Wolfhide. Yes. For making the Wolfhide stuff. And I want a Wolfhide. Well, I mean, you want Wolfhide everything. Pants, boots, hat. Hat. Oh, I can make Wolfhide anything. What do I want? A Wolfhide hat. That'd be nice. I think a Wolfhide hat would look really nice. Don't you? I think it would. Put the Wolfhide hat. So, you know, the Wolfhide hat gives us more cold protection than the Boarhide hat did, which is now obviously garbage. I'm just gonna turn that into rags. Like I mentioned earlier, that's actually a thing that I don't like about the game, is even though I've equipped all this stuff, my character model remains the same. It would have been a nice touch if we would have gotten to actually, like, see the outfit on us. Or even if we got to see the outfit on the little portrait in the center of the screen there. It just would have been a nice touch. But we don't. So that's that. That's that. My character portrait makes it look puffy and stuffy. Yeah, I mean, you know. Of course she's probably puffy and stuffy. She's just out here in the woods. Surviving. Oh shit, I am hungry. I better eat. How about some jerky? That sounds great. Some shit to the raft. So we have more space in our backpack. Great. 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 Off we go. I think the game did well. I mean, obviously the game did well enough on Kickstarter to be made. I just believe it's one of those, like, really small... Fuck. Can't reach it. Now I'm gonna crash. Ooh, just missed it. I think it was just a small team behind the game, and so, you know, they just didn't have a lot of time for stuff like that. Overall, that is a really minor complaint, I will say. It just would have been nice. Very minor complaint. Like, if this were a AAA title, that's something that I would, that I think would be expected. Any sort of, you know, if you change your outfit, it should reflect in-game. But it's not a AAA game, so it's okay. And the game is good enough without it. Don't. I really can't take any show that airs on the CW seriously. You know, are we talking about Arrow? Are we talking about Flash? Who saw the season finale of Flash and saw them completely shit the bed? I am a fan of Flash. And, fucking wolves. Look at these fucks. Get out of here. Get out of here. You can kind of scare them away with your stick. Get out of here. Fucking hell. This is a hospital tour. I might want to stay here until daybreak. Flash is fun. Flash is a really, really fun... Oh, you're talking about Felicity. Oh. No, Flash is a really fun show, but the way this season ended made me very upset. For some reason... Shows and movies based off of comic books are starting to pick up the worst traits in comic books. And the Flash, I won't spoil it for anyone who hasn't seen the season finale yet, but they did something this season that just pissed me right off. And I'm a fan of the show, but they did something so stupid that it kind of makes me question whether or not I will continue to watch The Flash. Mark Hamill was fine on The Flash. He was playing a low-rent Joker, and so he was playing the Trickster, but he was using his Joker voice from Batman the Animated Series, and so that kind of was off-putting to me. CW will probably bring in a new Flash, black or Hispanic, maybe. That will be the next thing. And no, it's... they. Like I said, I don't want to spoil anything, because if someone is watching the show, they won't want it spoiled. But we talked about this a little bit during our tiny Captain America Civil War discussion. And yeah, this won't be any spoilers for Civil War, but I was a little disappointed by Captain America Civil War. The story was really unfocused, and there were... all over the place, and it didn't feel... it felt like two stories smushed into one, which I feel is a flaw with a lot of comic books, where it's a lot of stories smushed into one. Right now I'm waiting for daytime so I can go in and loot this place without wolves being there. No, so I don't want to pause because I'm waiting... so now it's daytime, so I believe the wolf... what? Are they just here?
I don't know.
I can't sleep. You can only sleep at a shelter or a fire. So I can't sleep right here. I know I need to sleep and I'm getting... oh, actually I can drink some water. Fill up the water jar, so I got that. The Civil War was good. I really liked Civil War, but it is clearly two movies smushed into one. It is very clearly Captain America, The Winter Soldier Part 2, and The Avengers Civil War. And those two movies... ah, fuck, I gotta go. I can't deal with the wolves. Very, very clearly. And we... oh, and it stopped raining, apparently. And we could have had two movies with very focused narratives, and instead we got a shit show because they needed a spectacle. Oh, fuck, I gotta repair my raft. So overall, it was fine. There's no good reason Spider-Man should be in the movie. there's no good reason, you know, for a lot of things in the movie, but... The Riddle of Steel, no, I have not addressed the porn parody yet. I absolutely refuse to even glance in that direction. I'm on Reddit. I saw someone post a link to it. I am not going to watch it. Why? Because why would I? What do I need? I need some hardware, so that is my official addressing. That. Now I think I can make... oh, if I could make a raft storage, that would be useful. Yes. Right, so I just upgraded my raft storage, which is incredibly useful. Great. Now I need to find a place to sleep. Spider-Man is not part of the greater theme of responsibility and accountability. No. No, he's in there because they got the rights to use Spider-Man. I know what part you're talking about as far as, like, accountability and responsibility, and they did not dwell on that nearly long enough if that was supposed to be part of the theme. If you're talking about the fight and Tony's conversation with him afterwards. we needed it to be a bigger deal, but it couldn't be a bigger deal because it was two movies dipped into one. Spider-Man, it would have been great if he was part of the Avengers Civil War. But then the Winter Soldier should not have been a part of that. Picking up some cattails. Picking up some cattails. No, my dog is immortal. My dog cannot starve to death, and like the wolves cannot attack him. He cannot. The dog is immortal. He cannot hurt. You know, like Tarsuk says, if Marvel would have gotten Spider-Man earlier, and we would have gotten a solo Spider-Man movie, then he would have been more naturally integrated into the universe, and that's exactly it. That's what we needed. Let's get you a kit. All right, I'm asleep for a bit. Wasn't that why the original director of Ant-Man left all the Marvel Universe stuff that didn't fit into the movies? He didn't like Marvel's control over the property. He wanted to make his movie, and obviously Marvel wants to make Marvel movies. Rumor has it that Edgar Wright wanted to do a lot more with Evangeline Lilly's character. Yeah, I'll take the ambulance. Great. And that's where some of the bad blood came from, is he wanted to... This is... 100% pure rumor, as he has not spoken officially about this, but that he wanted the Wasp to have a greater role in the movie, and Marvel said no. Jar. I don't need eyes. I just don't need a fucking jar. I slept. Okay, great. Yeah. Oh yeah. No, that Ant-Man needed her. That Ant-Man has its problems too. Good night, Tyrannosaurus Rex. Thanks for stopping by. Oh, Anonymous. Sorry, I missed your tip earlier. Anonymous says, since most of the RLM team plays at least one instrument, will we ever see an RLM jam? Probably not. Both Josh and I are bass players. So, you know, then we got two bass players, and that's rough. I have played the drums in the past, so maybe I could switch over to drums. Just to make it easier. Just to fill out that niche. Jesse's singing, obviously, because no one else wants to hear anyone sing. I can assume you. Agreed. They need to make a 5-minute short of Michael Pena's character from Ant-Man describing Civil War. Yes, that would be wonderful. He was a breath of fresh air in Ant-Man. Draft. Great. Jack the Drumming Clown Butcher. Yes. Yes, yes, that is me. In bands before, I have played the drums. Obviously not very well, as I've never trained, but neither on the bass, so. Can we agree, new discussion, can we agree that the slick 90s Batmobile is the best Batmobile? everything's fine. Even the Tumblr had its moments, but can we just all agree that we need to stop making such a big deal out of the Batmobile? Really, if you think about it, like, any car is incredibly impractical for Batman. Because if it's a car, like even the 90s one, the slick 90s one, You're gonna stick out like a sore thumb, and Batman is a detective ninja. He needs to be incognito. What Batman needs is a cool motorcycle. That's the only thing that actually fits for Batman. A cool motorcycle that hides his cape and cowl so he can actually blend in and be unnoticed. No, the Nolan's Batmobile, the Tumbler, it's not bad. It made sense in the Nolan universe. The cycle from Dark Knight is the best Bat vehicle. Yeah, it was pretty cool. But, you know, again, like, the Batmobile's purpose is to get Batman from point A to point B. It needs to be an incognito vehicle. I remember seeing a mock-up on it online. Someone said that the actual best vehicle for Batman would be, like, a tricked-out van. Ooh, hello, Devil's Trumpet. Well, oh, fuck, ants. Ants. I got ants in my pants. Hello. Oops. Means things cured. Great. Devil's Trumpet means tainted meat. Really, a flying vehicle would be best for a hero like Batman. Maybe. But again, incognito. It would need to be a flying vehicle that would be incredibly small as to not raise suspicion as he is flying through the city. And so again, you know, like, to me, that's motorcycle. Motorcycle is the way to go.
Take all that.
You know, the best for Batman is a minivan. You get a minivan, but then, you know, you black out all the windows. You tint all the windows. And it just looks like a, like, whatever the most popular selling minivan from like 3 years ago was, that's your Batmobile. You know why? Anyone sees a minivan rolling down the street, they're not gonna think twice. It's a minivan. Who would think anything of a minivan? Then it can fit all your bat shit. You can get like a cage in the back. Like, you know, hold all your villains. It has plenty of storage for all of your bat gadgets. A bat minivan is the practical choice for Batman. Let's start a petition, an online petition to get Batman into a minivan. Oh, hey, there's my timer. And as we talk, where are you ringing? As we talk about Batman's minivan, let's all stand up. Let's stand up to make sure our legs are no longer atrophied. Batman is more about intimidation, not stealth. I would say it's a nice mix of both. And yes, a minivan is not that intimidating. I'll admit that. But I still think he needs to be able to move around the city without being noticed. It's clear that you're a wonderful family man if you think giving Batman a minivan is a great idea. It's, you know, if we're gonna bring realism. Oh, I was already here. Into the Batman universe, I think this needs to be addressed. Which is, he's driving all around the city in a car that looks like a bat. everyone is going to know exactly where he is all of the time. How can he expect to stop crime? You know, if I was a crime boss in Gotham, I would just have people stationed around the city reporting in whenever they saw Batman's funky-ass Batmobile. We would have constant tabs on him. He would never be able to surprise us, right? Empty. And that's the real problem with the Batmobile, is he loses all advantage, all elements of surprise.
Ooh, mulberries.
Oh, look at this. See that up there? Here, hold on. Get the mouse. See this? That is a sleeping wolf.
Fucker doesn't even know I'm gonna kill him. I'm gonna fucking kill him.
What am I gonna do here? You know what I got? Tainted bait. Boom. And throw it right at him. Oh, you want some meat? You want some meat, puppy?
Just gonna kill the motherfucker. He doesn't even know.
He doesn't even know I'm gonna kill him. Boom. Boom. Killed him. I should probably pick up some more ammo. I mean, it's here. Cell phones break so many plots. They do. They do. And that's... You know what? That might be like an issue with the Nolan verse. Where he... You know, if you try to bring realism into something like comic books and superhero stuff, you have to start accounting for stuff like cell phones. Jerky.
Fuck yeah. Mulberries. Fuck yeah.
The country music plus Wolf Death. Yes! Wolf Death. I would go see the band Wolf Death. Baboon should just have a bet. Batman should just have a baboon that drives a tank on his side. What? Let's put bats back in the late 30s. It's just one of those things where once you live, if you are a criminal and you live in a city where Batman or any superhero operates who also has a giant, immediately recognizable vehicle, it's very easy to keep tabs on that person. Oh, fuck, I made another bow. God fucking damn it, I don't need another bow, can I? I accidentally made another bow. I don't need another bow. I was seeing what I could make now that I was at the workbench. Batman should take a lesson from Captain America and steal all of his vehicles. You know, that would be a... Schematic. That would be a way to get around. Best Batmobile was the one from the 80s where he just drove around in a black sports car. I don't know. I don't know that one. But you know, that's the point. It needs to be an incognito thing. Does the gear wear out in this game? No. Your gear never wears out, but you'll see, like, if you look at my knife here, the light brown is slowly diminishing. As I use them to craft items, the more dark brown you have, the more worn it is. So these, like, your tools will wear down and your bow will wear down. But I don't believe your clothes ever wear down. At least they didn't on my first playthrough. Alright, move all that stuff to the racks. Great. Great, we're doing great. Keep Jack distracted so we can get his character killed. Right! Keep talking about Batmobile, other... Oh, bullshit, you're gonna get me killed. He drove a sports car in the comic. That made sense. That would make sense. Something fast. Something that could pass for an ordinary car, but was still pretty badass. That makes sense to me. I am pro team sports car. So the bow is a spare. Yes, the bow will be a spare. I did not mean to craft that bow. It's just a sapling and some braided cord, so it's not like a major loss, but I accidentally crafted that. I do want to stay away from the rapids. A bad boat. Campground. That's alright. We'll see if there's anything here. He drove a sports car in the dark night. Not the movie. I mean, he drove a sports car. Bruce Wayne drove a sports car, but this game is making me sleepy. Yeah, it's very calm. Fucking hell, wolves. Fuck you. Fuck you, wolves. God damn it. God fucking hell. Nope. Now I gotta go. I need to sleep. Everything's terrible now. Fucking wolves. Great. And now I'm entering the deep country, which has few docks. Fuck. Fuck, 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 fuck. And I'm gonna get exhausted. Where's Rich? Rich is on vacation this week. Rich is not worrying about any video production this week. Spending some time with loved ones. So you're gonna get two Jack solo streams. I'm gonna try to talk Lisa into some board games Wednesday night. So we'll see. If not, you just got me. ABC, always be crime fighting. Which Rich worries about video production, but Rich does a lot at Red Letter Media. He builds stuff. Oh, we're getting to a plot point in the game. Look, we're to a dam. Damn. No Overwatch. If I was playing Overwatch, and I did think about it, because I know I'm thirsty. If I was playing Overwatch, I would not be able to interact with the chat at all. There would just be far, far too much going on screen, and I'd have to pay attention. So I decided no Overwatch, because then I just wouldn't be able to chat with the chat at all. Actually gonna sleep for a little bit. But who gave Rich permission to leave? I'm sure someone did. He didn't ask me. He told me he was leaving. Play some Overwatch. I'm not playing Overwatch. You guys would just be telling me to roll all the time. All right, here's Flim Flam.
Fair weather, stranger. You strike me as the kind appreciates a barter. Flim Flam's the name. Equitable trade's my game. Pardon the little roadblock. Be glad to spring it right open for a small favor.
Oh, whoopsie. I said you're in my way.
Yep. Need a spot of help. Been trying to get an old radio relay powered up to advertise my wares. That switch needs to be flipped, but I gotta stay down here to keep an eye out to see what I'm getting at.
Where's the switch?
Glad to hear you're on board. Run up that hill behind me, throw the switch at the top, make sure everything spins up okay. Do that very thing, and I'll get the river cleared up for you. Am I up on tips? Ooh, sorry, the riddle of steel. Okay, the riddle of steel, I acknowledge your tip. And we are not... How about that? Let's see here. Sure is, I'll be on your way in no time. I'm a straight shooter, you see? Flim flam, honest as the day is long. Yes, my character does look like she's been beaten up a bit. I think that's purposeful. And I'm also hungry. I should eat some jerky. I got some joiky. I know, no, what you said, the riddle of steel, was not racy. That's just a big old nope for me. Big old nope, 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 nope. Nope, 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 nope. Okay, so Flim Flam needs me to go up this thing here and flick a switch. And... Please proceed to Angel Yards for evacuation. What's the last CD I bought? Actually, I just bought one. I just bought Animal Collective Painting With. Fun album. They got that Florida Da Da song. Just a summer party right there, and then the rest of the album is very weird. I just bought it. Because we still have a CD player in one of the cars, and so my wife likes it if I get actual CDs. And then that's the last physical CD I bought, and then I just downloaded for me on iTunes The Impossible Kid, which I talked about, Aesop Rock. Fuck yeah, Aesop Rock. Impossible Kid, really great album. Where the hell is Rich Evans? Rich Evans is on vacation. Rich Evans is gone. He'll be back. Everything's coming along. Now that them folks on the radio saying them fine goods ain't gonna trade themselves, where the rubes, I mean upstanding citizens at? Rich is on vacation. Aesop Rock sounds fucking weird when he raps, though. He sounds great. I don't know what you're talking about. He sounds great. And he is great. He's the greatest. Great. This guy's talking to me. I don't care. Got me here some insulated boots. Give them to you for a bow. Get out of here, insulated boots. Deal seems well stacked in your favor, Flim Flam. I'm not giving you a bow. Insulated boots. Can you believe that shit? Insulated boots, my ass. Kill Flim Flam and take his stash. If only you could. Jack, I am totally hip with the rap. I have an extra bow, but I don't need insulated boots. I already have... What boots do I have right now? I already have boarhide boots, which are significantly superior to insulated boots. That's a slap in my face, insulated boots.
Get charcoal.
Yeah.
Aesop Rock is greater than Aesop Rocky. I agree with you, though I still enjoy Aesop Rocky. Long Live, I think, is a really fun hip-hop album, especially if you are into like the really brash, terribly sexist hip-hop, which can be fun sometimes. Long Live ASAP Rocky is a really fun album. That's a really fun hip-hop album. Take it. Take it. Dude, Wu-Tang ain't nothing to fuck with. And everyone knows that Wu-Tang Clan ain't nothing to fuck with. Have I ever been to a hip-hop concert? Yes, I have been. I've been to good ones. I've been to some really good ones. Usually the concerts I go to are little smaller, like local hip-hop artists. But I've been to some really fine ones. No wait. No wait. Raft. 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 Sarah Chen, you're just saying pew pew. That doesn't mean anything. That doesn't mean anything. Nah, the whitest man alive would have talked about a Tribe Called Quest. Tennessee. Tennessee. Of course, the Tribe Called Quest. I think some of them are from the Wisconsin area. No, you know, I think, you know, I enjoy all sorts of music. Hip-hop just being one of them. I really enjoy the craft of rapping. If I can say anything whiter. Don't know what it is. I enjoy the craft. I enjoy the storytelling. I enjoy the flow and the beat. It's not time to stand up yet. Is it time to stand up yet? No, it's only 11:20. It is not time to stand up yet. A. Farron says, good job on the multitasking with the game and the chat. That's why I'm doing a game like this. Because I can. I can multitask, play a little bit, check out the chat a little bit. Yes, I do have some filters. I'm going to make some clean water. Am I going to get Jay to play Outlast 2? Maybe. Maybe. We will talk to Jay about playing video games. You know how Jay feels about video games. Which is, in general, he does not care about them. Okay. And we're off again. You could say that RZA is the Wu-Tang Clan's lead singer. You know, Wu-Tang had a good dynamic, had a good group dynamic. I have no tolerance for these games. Games are over. I love games. Saving not allowed. Nope. No saving here. They do this sometimes where, like, the flow of the river is really slow and there's no docks in the foreseeable future. And so, like, if I wouldn't have rested at that campfire, I would have started getting real sick. Like, I have food and water with me for this stretch, because sometimes you'll go a really long stretch without anything. And, you know, you see, like, the music's not playing. They want you to feel alone and abandoned. I think ODB was a bigger rapper than Method Man. Method Man did a lot of stuff outside of music that I think people might know him for, but if we're talking just musical names, Old Dirty Bastard definitely had a bigger name, if only for like his appearances on MTV and doing the weird, you know. Wasn't Old Dirty Bastard the one that like went and picked up his welfare check after he was a millionaire rapper? Oh, did my meat spoil? No, my raw meat is fine. But I got a moldy lump. I have raw meat, but it spoils after 4 days. I forget how long I've had it, but I need to do something with it soon. Oh, yeah, oh no, here it is. Yep, so I do have a spoiled meat. Which, you know, that's just... My kids just got into Pokemon cards. What's a good starter game to get them that's available now? Like a starter Pokemon game? Oh, just choose any of them. Obviously, like, depending on how old they are, you might not want to buy them, like, the new DS. So, like, see if you can find, like, an old Game Boy Advance. Like, those old Game Boy Advance SPs were backlit. Or, you know, they had the lighting integrated into the system. Buy them an old-ass system that you can get for super cheap, and then, you know, get the old Game Boy Advance Pokemon games. Those were great games. Spoiled meat. The Boar King. What? Put an end to the reign of Boar King. Shit, dog. Alright. Does that mean the Boar King is here?
The quilt of Television Tim. My stories is on Television Tim told the field reps who came a-callin'. He were the kind of body liked things a particular way. When his kin offered him a bigger set, he declined, 'cause it meant moving round his furniture. When the broadcast stopped, he went taped reruns, complete with commercials.
I like that. Little stories of people who died, got trapped in the flood. Cattail. Oh shit. Boar King. See that? That right there? That's a big ass boar. That's a big-ass boar. Shit. Well, ain't that something special? Are you gonna run away, or you're gonna stay here too, like the wolves?
Mashed potatoes.
I like that voice. That, like, old...
Oh, fuck you.
Boar King. How close can I get to you? Can I cheese you, Boar King? I'm totally gonna cheese the Boar King. I don't know if one trap will do it for him, though. Oh, did I get him? Nope, he is not dead yet. Alright, no, that's fair. I will build another spear trap, and we'll save two spear traps. Do we know why the world is post-apocalyptic? We just know that there's a flood. There was a flood. And that's all we know. Alright, we're gonna cheese him again. Two traps does not get the Boar King. All right. Maybe a third trap will get the Boar King. Hello, Boar King. I'm sorry to cheese you, but sometimes one must cheese. Hey, come on, trip the trap here. There we go. Three spear traps to kill the Boar King. Four raw meats and three boar hides. That's beautiful. That is beautiful. Knife that fucker. I can't. You cannot directly attack your enemies in this game. You have to use traps. But I did it. I have murdered the Boar King. For what that is worth. I actually don't know if it's worth much. I mean, it's worth a bunch of meat and a bunch of hides. I'm gonna have to cook that meat or else it's all gonna spoil.
Nuts and bolts. Nuts and bolts. Nuts and bolts.
At this point, I could really use some flint. If I had some flint, I could make some arrows. Salt. Oh, okay, I can make some jerky. Make some jerky while I can. And I think I might have a fire in here. The boar had three kids and a wife. Well, I don't care. That boar's marital status, family status, is no concern of mine. Oh, I do have a fire. Alright, I gotta cook some meat. Quick, put on They Might Be Giants Flood to fill the mood. Yeah, you know. Then we'd have a DM, a digital rights management claim on our hands. We're gonna cook some meat. I also think it's kind of lazy that there's no going into buildings. I'm okay with that. You can, you know, you loot the building if there's a door open. Going into buildings would kind of be redundant. So I'm gonna be okay with that. Just because why not? This is the only thing I can make. Make some more braided cores. Tom Waits is gonna issue a DRM on the stream because of my voice.
Tom Waits.
Yeah, a little Tom Waits. Yeah. I need to eat. I'm gonna eat you. Get you out. I'm not gonna eat the spoiled meat. That would be dumb. But I am gonna eat one of you meats. Great. And I'm gonna drink some water. But not right now. What's wrong with her face is she was, She's tired. I'm gonna sleep. Sleep for 6 hours. Why? Because then it's less dark. Did I search you already? Fucking crow, get the fuck out of here. Fucking fuck. Your body temp is 100 out of 100 and your thermometer looks red. The icon looks sick. The icon looks sick because I need water. I don't have any water. Oh, and it was raining. God damn it. I wasn't thinking. I need water. But I have water, so it's okay. Now watch. After I drink my water, then my icon starts to look a little bit better. The thermometer is getting down there. My body temperature is not 100% anymore. I could use some more water, though. I think I have one more filter. I do. I have one more filter, which means I can get one more clean water out of my filter. But that's okay. I got that charcoal. At a campfire, you can get the charcoal. And then you can make a water filter with charcoal, cattail, and rags. So boom, more water filters. If you have the right tool, you can use the spoiled meat to make a poison bait trap to lure and kill carnivores. Yes, young bubbles. Actually, what you need is something called the devil's trumpet, which is a purple plant. It's a plant with a big purple flower on it. You mix that with any meat, cooked meat or raw meat, and you can make tainted bait, which wolves will eat and be poisoned from. That is amazing. That is an amazing tool for killing wolves that I use a lot. Len, I cannot tell you. I know we are working on scheduling the next best of the worst right now. I have no idea. If I remember correctly, if you go under here, you can lose stuff. Yeah. I have no idea when it will be or what. Or what we're doing for the next best of the worst. But we are working on getting schedules together right now. I think that the problem with these survival games is that the developer makes most of the mechanics within a vertical slice. And as a player, you don't ever get to the kind of point... Maybe I missed part of that conversation, Splugel. Like, most of these survival games take hours to open up to the real meat of them. Well, I think that's actually something that The Flame and the Flood has in its favor, which is, and this hasn't happened on my run yet, but it is roguelike and it is procedurally generated. So if I die, the world starts over again. And I think that's something that this game has in its favor, is learning from death. And, you know, like, I'm doing well this time, but my first playthrough, I must have died at least 10 times just because I didn't know any better. And now, of course, I kind of know what everything does. I know how to craft items. I know what items I need to have on hand in case I run into a snake, in case I run into a wolf. But a lot of those lessons learned were through death early on. And so I think actually that's where this game succeeds. Jack's people have to call Mike's people and coordinate with Rich's people. Yeah, well, you know, there's a lot of schedules to go through. A lot of schedules. Best of the Worst is an all-day affair. I think we've talked about this before, where... I don't need any more cattails. I could eat them, but I don't need any more, because I have a bunch of meat. Alcohol and old lumber. Just what any able-bodied American needs. You just give me some 2x4s and some... Oh, fucking hell, I was just opening up the one thing. You have to hold down the A button to open up the workbench, and then I held it down for too long and accidentally crafted a bandage. I mean, that's not the worst thing in the world, having an extra bandage, but... Still. I did not want a bandage at that time. How many hours do I have logged into the game? I will shift tab. I currently have 20 hours into the game, including tonight's session. I have beaten it. Oh, fuck, wolves. Look at that. The wolf is just eating something else. Like, the animals can fight. So that might have been a boar, could have been a rabbit, and the wolf is just eating something else. So I am going to run away. But now if I run into a crow, the crow could tip that wolf off. I'm going to explore a little bit and just know that there is a wolf over there. Let's see if there's anything I can search the car. Pretty sure your character is dying slowly. No, no, look at her. Look at the portrait now. Now she looks fine. She's well hydrated. She had plenty to eat. She has plenty to sleep. She's warm. Right now, we're fine. Oh, okay, so the thing about the thermometer. People keep pointing to the thermometer. Let me tell you a little bit about that. Okay, so this up here, I got the miles here, this up here is the current temperature, and when the red drops, that means it's getting colder. This yellow line is where my current equipment gets me. And so I'm good until the red drops below this yellow line. Because right now, I currently have a wolfhide hat, wolfhide gloves, boarhide boots, boarhide pants, and a wolfhide jacket. So like right now I'm pretty good. Clothing wise, eventually you do run into bears. Bears are really tough to kill, but so I can get some better clothes, but right now I'm actually pretty well stocked as far as equipment for the trip is concerned. The other thermometer, the one on the body temp, yeah, and it's all red, which is good. Once this red starts to, don't worry about the picture of the thermometer, it's just this red circle. Like, see the green circle here for my food. It's when this outer red circle starts to drop. That's when we need to be concerned. I can make a boar jacket. The wolf jacket is better than the boar jacket. I think that's what we're confused about, is whether or not there's overheat. Oh, no, there's... Oh, so, sorry. You know, there's no overheating in the game. There is only cold. You only have to worry about the cold. It would be very interesting if, like, the weather turned up and you had to, like, unequip your nice wolf hide jacket if it got too warm, but I don't believe that is a mechanic, and if it is, it does not affect you at all. So then it wouldn't be. So no, that is not a mechanic. Can I guess Warcraft's Rotten Tomato scores? Ultimazer, I've heard really bad things. I'm going to assume it's at... I know nothing about the Warcraft movie. All I've heard is really bad reviews, so I'm going to assume it's at 40%. Ultimazer, 40 to 45%. How close am I? I'm watching the chat now, so I'm not totally paying attention. What is it? 19%? Shut the front door. It is at 19%. Oh, poor Warcraft. Why? Why are we making the Warcraft movie? Why is this a thing? Sweet Jeebus Crisp. No, neither Rich or I have ever played WoW. Not that it matters, but it's a 7.9. It's a 7.9 on IMDb. Isn't that wonderful? How disparate those numbers are. 19% of Rotten Tomatoes, 7.9 on IMDb. Pause for one moment. I will be right back. I need to refresh my beverage. CG looks like crap in the trailer. It's a Warcraft movie. The audience for the movie is very limited. I feel like it's very limited. I can't imagine anyone outside of really the Warcraft community is watching the movie. That's right, they kind of had like sexy female orcs. Sapling. I just want to know what it's going to be about. What's the deal with the Warcraft movie? We got here, bunny. We got some bunny rabbits. Build us a rabbit trap. Salt means I can make jerky. Wait, don't I have... Oh no, I cooked all that meat. Okay, I can't make jerky. You know what? Never mind. I didn't want to make jerky. I did not want to make jerky. Everything's fine. You know what? I think actually that's the only good question with the Warcraft movie is did they make a Leroy Jenkins joke? That's the only thing that, you know, like the common man, that's the only thing they know of World of Warcraft. Oh, it's nighttime now. Oh. Well, fuck you. I'm taking my trap then. Rabbits don't come out at night. Yeah, she looks like she has pink eye because she's getting tired and she's getting hungry. Which is fine. I can sleep in the bus here. I just want to see if I can scavenge anything else. No, there's not really anything. And she's hungry, but I'll sleep first, then eat. Sleep for 6 hours just to make the nighttime go by faster. Great, and then we'll eat. And now, see, now she looks all right. And the garlic, and the garlic to consume. So all of you two to get the hydration. Great! And we're off. Did your kids ever catch pika? Oh, yeah. I mean, listen, once your kids start going to school, they catch everything. No, like... They catch pink eye all the time. It just happens. It just happens. Schools are nothing but petri dishes. That's fine. I just don't need a moldy lump. I'm gonna put that out there. I don't need spoiled meat. Why am I carrying that around? Why am I taking up space? Carrying around spoiled meat. Oh, here we go. I think I have plenty of supplies to build shit. And my raft could use some repairs, so we're gonna swing by this dock right here. Shit, yeah. Do kids still get lice? They do. They do. And you know, if one kid gets it, like, for our school, we had a lice outbreak last year, and our kids had to bring their backpack in a garbage bag to school every day for, like, 3 months because this one family kept getting lice, and it was just annoying as shit. And, you know, like, you know, your kid gets lice, yeah, it happens, you know, you clean it up, but it's like, they... Like, it was the same family kept getting lice, and everybody knew it. And it, eventually, it was just one of those things where you're like, does someone need to have a talk with this family? So yeah, that still happens. Then you gotta do lice checks every night. Because, you know, once it's in your house, you just cannot get it gone. Knock on wood, we have not had it. But yeah, all that shit still happens. That's the thing, young bubbies, where it's like that was, you know, I don't have hair, so it's like if we ever did get it, I'm fine. They would never attach to me. Ooh, here we go. I can make a sturdy frame. I do want to make a sturdy frame. My raft. And some moderate repairs to my raft. Because you never know when you're going to run into some shit. Could make a minor repair, so it'd just be 100%. Or I could... Hardware and frame. Can I make a hardware and frame? I would kind of like a rudder. I might as well make a hardware. Oh yeah, the singing's back, I know. How do you get rid of lice? Yeah, you need a special soap. And you need to clean... you need to disinfect everything. Anything that head has touched. A hat. A bed. If the kid itched their head and then touched anything. Like, everything needs to be disinfected. And you need to use a special soap, or you need to completely shave the kid's head. It is not a fun situation from what I've heard. Alright, great. It would be fine. Like, for me, it's fine. You know? No hair off my head. But, yeah. For those with hair, it's a whole to-do. It's a whole to-do. I'm in the rapids. Gotta get out of the rapids. And that's why you repair your ship. Great. Oh, actually, great. Because it's raining, I can get some water. Going to net money, the guy on this music track has ins with the devs. I'm sure, or perhaps just the devs were fans of this guy's music, and you know, like, I looked at the Kickstarter, and I believe like one of the pledges was like an exclusive soundtrack with the musician. So I don't believe he is like a, I don't think he's a composer, this musician. I think like he's just a regular musician. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. Wolves, wolf, 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 wolf. Don't eat me, wolf. But that's okay, because I'm going to cheese you. Tainted bait. And throw the tainted bait. Ooh, an achievement. I love it that achievements are popping. I enjoy achievements in games. I know Rich doesn't necessarily care about them, but I like achievements in games. And it was really upsetting to me when the achievements were not popping in this game due to a bug. But they are now. Ooh, rabbits. I'm gonna catch me some rabbits. Flint. I need flint. I have a decided lack of... Get out of here, you fucking crow. A decided lack of flint. And I am... Ooh, yes, devil's trumpet. This is it right here. Look at this. This bright purple flower. Devil's trumpet. You can mix that with raw meat and make tainted meat. And that kills a wolf instantly. It's great. Oh fuck. Oh fuck. Bork, 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 bork. Fuck, 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 fuck. Mulberries. No, wait. The boar's still chasing me. Fuck, fuck, fuck. Okay. I need flint for my bow and arrow. If I had a bow and arrow, I could take care of this boar very easily. Bork, 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 bork. Hey. You dickhead boar, come here. Come here. Chase me. Chase me, boar. I know, you know my trap is right here. Come here. Come here. What is wrong with you? Come here, you jerk. You know what this is? This is a smart boar. Come here. Fall into my trap. Come here and fall into my trap, you horrible dickhead. There we go. That took a lot more than I thought it would to kill that boar. The boar has adapted. Need some flint so I can make arrows. That's what I really need here. Ants. Oh, but here are some rabbit holes. Alright, if I build... Okay, so I can build some snares here. Catch some rabbits. Damn it, boar, let me kill you, right? That's exactly what it was. I had a perfectly good trap there. I wanted to kill a boar. The boar had other ideas. Hold on, we're gonna lay down some rabbit traps for the morning here. Alright. Now we can catch some rabbits. We're gonna need some rabbits for later on. Now I'm gonna sleep for a bit. Sure. Would RLM ever make a serious film? I mean, like a drama or a romance. Well, they made The Recovered. Did I catch two rabbits? No, just one. That's fine. The Recovered is a serious film. You know, it's like a suspense thriller, I think. I actually don't know what you would call it, but I think it's supposed to be like a suspense horror film. So yes, RLM would make. Ooh, there we go. Now I heard it. I heard the rabbit. Give me a rabbit. Great. And now we skin a rabbit. Ooh, now I can make jerky. Yes. The Recovered doesn't count? Why not? That's a series. That was a while ago and it's relatively low budget, but I think that counts as a serious movie. I think it should count as a serious movie. I have way too many cattails. And not enough braided cords. Great. Need saplings. No, don't make pouch. No, don't make pouch. Okay, time to get out of here. What is this? I I've never seen a Nostalgia Critic. You know, Rich and I have talked about this before, where it's like, you know, we just kind of don't watch other people's stuff because it's what we do. But I hear good things or bad things. I just don't. I also just don't pay attention. I should really start paying attention to anything. We're doing good. I think, you know, obviously we're on a good run here. We're on a fine run here. I'm almost like upset now that I did. I'm on the easier difficulty. There's two difficulty settings. I am on the easier difficulty. Probably should have done the harder one, but I like the pace. Like how you did. Oh my god, leftover beef. Have you guys seen Creed? I finally got around to seeing Creed over the weekend. One, I'm a huge Rocky fan. I've seen and love all the Rocky movies for very different reasons. And I had never gotten around to seeing Creed. And Jeebus Crisp, that is a brilliant movie. That's a great Rocky movie, a great way to move the series forward. Had me just blubbering like a baby. I was so into it. That Michael B. Jordan. Just into it. You should watch all the Rocky movies, because all the Rocky movies are great for very different reasons. Make sure you understand that they're great for different reasons. Dandelions right now. Rabbits. You know, I don't want to waste my saplings on snares to get rabbits, because I need spear traps in case I need to kill, like, real threats. But I will need rabbit pelts eventually. I only have two right now. I don't need any cattails. Just don't need it. It's better than there. I think, you know what? I think Creed is up there with the original Rocky. Original Rocky is a whole beautiful movie to its own, and Creed is up there with the original Rocky. Just, you know, tells a great character piece, and also has dudes punching each other. I did see Rocky Balboa, but I was on the reefer, so it didn't sink in. See Rocky first. Rocky is a beautiful movie. You can skip all the other ones and go see Rocky Balboa, which is another beautiful character movie. You know, because they're simple. They're simple stories just about characters that happen to involve dudes punching the shit out of each other. Which is the beautiful thing. You get both. Dudes punching the shit out of each other. And nice character movies. Isn't that all we want? Creed is basically a remake, but it's also a passing of the torch. Creed is what we should have gotten with, like, an Indiana Jones and the Crystal Skull. Where it pays homage to the original, it does its best to emulate the original, but it does so in a new generation, in a new style, and it passes on the torch. Fucking fantastic movie. I know nothing about Black Panther as a character. I don't give a shit about Black Panther. Now that I know the director of Creed is making Black Panther, I care about that movie now. So fucking good. And it's just, you know, it's just upsetting because everyone said it was good, but never got around to it. Joikey. Rocky is amazing. Yeah, Sly was nominated for an Oscar for writing it. And you're right. And in Creed, no one gets nuked in a fridge. So, you know, it's like win-win. Jeebus. Oh, there we go. Look at that guy. See them right here? I'll try to get close enough so you can see him. This guy right here, Snake. That's why you get the dandelion tea. If a snake bites you, you get poisoned. And your hydration level drops immediately, and your fatigue drops immediately, and it is a pain in the ass. And the snakes, you know, like, they don't often make noise, and like, they're hiding. Here's another one. Fucking snakes. The really fun thing is actually if there is a boar or a wolf here, the snakes can take care of them for you. Like, if you can get a boar to run into a snake will bite it and kill the boar for you, and then you just have to scare off the snake. That's what I hate about the current Hollywood studio system. They didn't nurture the current generation of directors and now are just picking anybody who had a small success to take on massive pictures, then they're mad when they don't turn out well. You know, I think some of that, though, is the producer's fault. If the producer isn't going to be there to help a new director out when they do get a big movie, that's what you get with Fan4Tastic, right? The director had a mild success with Chronicle. Is that a snake? No, it's not a snake. And then gets a huge Hollywood franchise movie and buckles under the pressure. But was that because the producers weren't there assisting them? It's something I'm not necessarily worried about with the Marvel movies, because they have such a system in place to get what it is they're looking for, where I think they are there to help the director, obviously whether the director wants it or not. That's why some directors can't handle it. But I think you need a strong producer if you are going to cherry pick the young talent, and you need the young talent. And in the case of Creed, if I were a producer and I saw Creed, I would give that director anything to make a movie for me. If he can pull that together, that director can handle a lot. I don't know who De Laurentiis was. Was he the producer of Fan4Tastic? Marvel movies are paint by numbers directing at this point. Well, you know, they are and they aren't. you can still have your Guardians. You can still have your fringe movies where the director gets to shine a little bit. And I think Black Panther is going to be one of those situations, because Black Panther is a relatively unknown character, and off in Wakanda, he's doing his own thing. So I think he's going to be able to get away with a lot that, say, an Iron Man or a Captain America isn't able to get away with, as far as director flair is concerned. I've forgotten so many things. We don't speak of those Marvel movies. Yeah, Black Panther made perfect sense in Civil War. I need for a rudder. I need framework. I need a raft framework. I need some shit for my raft. Who's Colin Trevorrow? What movie did he do to get episode 9? I have no idea who that person is. I'm gonna wait. If I sit here and twiddle my thumbs for a couple minutes, it will be morning time. And so that is what I'm going to do. Jurassic World?
Jesus.
Maybe with a better script, he could do something. I see. I know my body temperature is dropping, but it's going to be morning soon, and once the sun comes up, my body temperature will be fine. I have wiggle room there. I'm worried about finding a place to sleep, and I don't want to go in there with... I'm sure there's going to be wolves, because there's always fucking wolves late in the game, so I'm just going to wait for morning. Good night, Gungan38. Thanks for stopping by. Good night, Jack Trigger Joyce. Thank you for stopping by. Oh my god, and I have completely missed a bunch of tips. Sorry that my tip isn't working right, or my tip notification isn't working. Let's see here. Sarah Chen says, "Hey Jack, thanks for the combing stream tonight. Looking forward to Wednesdays. Also, can't wait for you and Rich to do another episode of Phoenix Wright again soon. Don't want to forget about the story evidence." Yes, we will be doing more Phoenix Wright. Anonymous says, "Jack, is that cute, adorable dog cookable?" Like, if there's not a food around, that would be horrifying. No. The cute, adorable dog is not cookable. And Sarah Chen says, "P.S. This darn 200 character limit." I did not know there was a character limit for your tips. Empty. Yes, we need these. We are low on saplings. Right now I'm looking for lumber. I could really go for some lumber. To fix up our raft. Actually, oh, and a boar. You know what? I just actually don't want to deal with that boar. Oh, go back to where you are. I don't care about you, boar. I need a place to sleep. Ooh, lumber. Great. Got some lumber. Makes it hard saying some things at you, because then I'd have to edit shit and it wouldn't fit, and hence some people have all these acronyms. Oh yeah, yeah. I believe it. And I just don't know all the acronyms. Okay, good. Here's a place to sleep. Oh, fuck, you're right. I should have gotten some water while it was still raining. Oh, fuck. Wasn't thinking. Was thinking about sleeping. My mind was sleeping. What? Are you over here now? Yeah, fuck you, boar. I don't care about you. I don't want anything you have. That boar thinks he's hot shit. I ain't got what you're selling. I want it. Craft frame. There we go. Now we can make some shit. The rogue one we shoots could be bad, but in this stage, everyone of knowing everything, I bet it's the kind of stuff that used to happen in movies all the time. Like we talked about last stream, what it means for sure is a drastic change in direction. Consume meat. That's all we know for sure, and I don't think that is necessarily a good thing. It could turn out to be good, sure, but... What? How? What? I just used that stitching kit. How did I use that stitching kit? What did I stitch up? Sometimes I just don't get what this game... I just don't get it. Shadow Elite 5. Jack says, would you be able to do more of this solo stream game? This game is enjoyable to watch, and it's perfect theme for your solo stream. Your stream is awesome. Oh, thank you. The game about going down the stream on the stream is fun. I used to do... Actually, Sundays used to be a Jack solo stream day, but then... Then we just turned it into a regular day. Perhaps. Yeah, perhaps we can do just like a regular Jack solo stream, if that's something you guys would be looking forward to. I know, like, my streams are a little more low-key. They're a little more low-key than our normal streams. And perhaps. Lurdiac, I am still going. I'm still alive. Shockingly, I'm still alive. I'm looking for Flint. Regular rich solo streams too. Oh, I agree, by the way. I totally agree. I think... Oh. Okay, there's a wolf. I'm gonna try... Oh, and there's an eating wolf, so I'm gonna try not to wake up those wolves. I see you, Mr. Snake.
The quilt of good Fildraj. For a religious fella, good Fildraj sure spent a lot of time arguing. Didn't seem to grant him much peace to all. Holler Dilly was red in the face about how what was occurring wasn't actually occurring. Said so in his ear book, he roared. No more earthly disaster. Not for the evacuation, sinkhole took his house, him with it. Still here shouting, some say.
This game does kind of pick on folk who don't believe in global warming, which, yeah, well, I am going to be okay with. Like, if I could chase some of the rabbits over here and get the snakes to kill the rabbits for me, then I wouldn't have to waste the resources to make a trap. That seems like a lot of... Oh, actually, man, what, there's just some rabbits right over here. Oh, there's a snake. Oh, shit. Wolf. Wolf, wolf, wolf. Wolf, wolf, wolf. Wolf, wolf. Ah, damn it. Oh, and a crow. So here's where the crow... comes into play, where if you don't scare away the crow fast enough, the wolf hears the crow and comes to investigate. Yes, this game, by the way, is 100% confirmed for liberal propaganda. I'm more than okay with that. The fuck wolf? That wolf did not see me. Wait, why are you there now? Shit, 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 shit. Hi, 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 wolf. Hi, 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 run, run. I am method. Yep, I spent time practicing in the bayou. Yeah, and you know what? This part of the soundtrack I'm actually perfectly okay with. I think this is fitting. It's a little, I agree, it's a little too upbeat, but I'm fine with it. Ooh, ooh. I'm a shill? What am I a shill for? I'm sure I'm a shill.
What do you need me to be a shill for? I'll shill for you.
Can I get it? Can I get it? Nope. Nope. I crashed. That's fine. That's fine.
Little crash. Little crash never hurt nobody. Yep. So the yellow bar underneath my portrait right now is the health of my raft. So not bad. Not good. There is a repair shop over there, so I can scoot over here. There we go. And get a repair going. Sounds like the beginning of Drinkenstein.
Yeah, a couple beers. You know, we're fine. Everything's fine. I don't know what you're talking about.
Here we go. Now we can get a rudder. So now we can steer a little easier. I'm gonna make some minor repairs. I'll be okay with that.
If you got the nuts and bolts.
You know, Hunchback Jack, I don't know if you're being sarcastic, but I do love the visuals. I love the art style of this game. I think it's very striking. Very. Scoot right over to you. You know, Godzilla, my boys really like Godzilla movies, so we've been marathoning some of the 90s Toho Godzilla movies this weekend, and we just saw Godzilla versus King Ghidorah. And if you've never seen Godzilla versus King Ghidorah, the plot involves time travel. Fucking wolves. No, not Godzilla versus King Ghidorah. But the actual plot involves heavily time travel, which you would not think possible in a Godzilla movie. One of the most batshit insane plots to a movie I've seen in recent memories. But somehow my boys were able to follow along. But it involves people from the future coming to the present to stop Godzilla from destroying Tokyo. And Godzilla was actually a dinosaur that was mutated after a H-bomb dropped. Fuck. Now I know there are the white wolf. Oh, fuck. Oh, is that the white? Oh, hey. Hey, come here. Come here. Where did he go? What? I gave him. First of all, what the fuck was that? What?
Folks say the White Wolf is some kind of a ghost. Ain't easy to kill a ghost. But they say if you manage to, the fur will give you powers.
Okay, so I gave the wolf some tainted meat and it ran away and survived the tainted meat.
Well, fuck.
Well, great. That was apparently the white wolf, and I was unable to kill it with tainted meat. So I just wasted a meat. Fuck you too, white wolf. What the fuck? Just confusing me more than anything. So in any case, people from the future come to the present to stop Godzilla from ever being born, and Godzilla was a dinosaur during World War II. Yes, that is real. And the H-bomb turned the dinosaur into Godzilla. And so they teleported, the people from the future, teleported the dinosaur into the ocean so it would never turn into Godzilla, but secretly planted some little bat-like creatures on the island to make King Ghidorah, because they actually didn't want to save Japan. They wanted to ruin Japan, because Japan was a major world power in the future. But as it turns out, Godzilla found radiation from somewhere else and still turned into Godzilla. And then he fought King Ghidorah that was actually trying to destroy Japan. And Godzilla won, but then Godzilla started destroying Japan, so the people from the future needed to go back to the future and recover the body of King Ghidorah and make a mecha King Ghidorah to fight Godzilla, who they were fighting in the... I don't care about spoilers. This movie was made in 1991. This is Godzilla versus King Ghidorah, the 1991 Toho Godzilla movie. It's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. It was insane. But the surprising part is you could actually follow the plot. Is this a fever dream you were describing? No, this is an actual thing that happens in the movie. You have to look it up. It's fun. It's a really fun... I mean, you know, Godzilla movies are always fun. Especially the, the 90s ones, I think, hit a real stride as far as still, like, watchable. But also, you know, they use the miniatures. It's a guy in a suit. I like the whole, you know, guy in a big rubber suit thing. I think it's funny. Care about this pig. I don't care about this pig. All monsters. I did not watch Godzilla. We watched. It was Godzilla versus King Ghidorah, and we watched Godzilla and Mothra, which is not cooked. Oh, do I only have it cooked? Godzilla and Mothra is Godzilla and Mothra versus Batra, other Mothra-type giant worm thing. It's a whole thing. Oh, I'm glad, Hunchback Jack. I'm glad you like the style of this game. I'm really digging the style of this game, too. Oh, it's raining. Drink the water. And gather the water. We have a couple other 90s Toho, like, you know, Godzilla 2000, Godzilla vs. Mechagodzilla. Fun stuff. I'm glad that my boys like that kind of stuff, or else I'd have to watch it alone. I am looking forward to the new Toho one. The problem is, part of the fun for me is the guy in a big rubber suit. And I just don't think we're getting that anymore. jar. I ain't no biddy who needs a jar. Saplings are good. I need some motherfucking flint up in here. That's what I need up in here. There's a rabbit. What's that? Well, that's disconcerting. Look at this. It's a car with a bunch of skulls. I don't like that none. Oh, look at that. Look at that man up there. Look at that skeleton man. Well, that's mighty concerning, don't you think? There's just not a whole lot I can do without flint. Can I make flint? Is that something I can craft? That would be great. I don't know if I've ever crafted flint before. This is a schematic of everything I can craft. Sorry if it's just going chick, 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 chick in your ear. No, you cannot craft flint. Okay. Ooh, here we go. Another story.
The Quilt of Tinfoil Pat. Few folk were more convinced of others trying to control their thoughts than old Pat Earl. Been wearing a tinfoil hat to delegate government mind beams for near 40 years when word came down about the evacuation. Reacted about how you'd expect. Bought all the aluminum a fella could carry. Hunkered down in his bunker. Ain't been seen since.
That's just cute. Cute little flavor. I'm okay with that kind of story. Flavor.
Tinfoil hat paint.
There's a workbench, but I ain't got nothing to make. I ain't got nothing much to make, you know what I'm saying? I don't need no water right now, I just drank. I need a place to sleep. I can build a fire. Wait, can I build a fire? I need a place to sleep. You saw a battleship? Why would you do such a thing, Altamazer? Why would you do that to yourself? To your loved ones? Why would you put us through that pain of knowing that another person has watched Battlefield? Why would you do such a thing? Need a place to sleep. Hello, bus. You look like you are a place to sleep. And you were a place to sleep. Great. Flint. We need flint. Flint, yeah. Shit, yeah. Now I can make some. I can make one arrow now. More flint! Yes, flint. Flint. boar? Doesn't look like there's much over there. Let's see if there's anything over here. Ooh, mulberries.
Ooh, mulberries.
Yeah, that's fine. What? Fuck you, boar. Now, this boar is just upset because I don't want it. You know, I don't want anything to do with it. I ain't interested in what you're selling. I don't need your bull meat, your bull hide. I don't need nothing but your bull and ass, you know what I'm saying? Know what I'm saying? Drinking water. And filling jar. And moving on. 100% cheesed. I've been saying that a lot all night, cheesing. Does everyone know what cheesing is? Is when you kind of exploit a game's rules to do something that probably should be difficult to easily. It's very easy to cheese in this game because there is a clear border in which the wild animals stop chasing you. That is a known term. Oh shit. Wolf. Wolf. Hey wolf, look, a snake. I probably shouldn't be daring myself. Oh! Fuck, yep, I shouldn't have been doing that. Oh good, the snake got the wolf. Fuck. What do I have? Laceration. I need a bandage. Okay, I have a bandage. Okay, fine. Oh fuck, another wolf. Yep, not this one. Fuck. Okay, everything's fine. Two tainted baits. I don't need anything in there. It's fine. I had a laceration, so I needed a bandage. But I had a bandage, so it's okay. I should take some of my rags and turn them into bandages. Run away? I know, I was pushing it. I just wanted to see if the snake would kill the wolf. I actually don't even know if the snake killed the wolf, but... I have a million rags and alcohols here, so I should... make some bandages. What? Evil Dead Tim? That doesn't... what? You're absolutely right, Dr. Vector. Some lumber to make the RAF shelter upgrade. I need a place I can sleep, in which I don't need to go and look for shelter inside. That would be preferable. Alright, let me mix up. RAFT. Raft. Consume. I gotta also organize my shit here. All my shit's all out of order. My knife's almost gonna break. Motherfucker. Ow. I don't know if you heard that. That was my jaw. My jaw just cracked. All right. All right. Lumber. Everybody think lumber. We're gonna start searching for lumber. Lumber. Empty. Also, if my dog would... Oh, snake, that's why. My dog would stop growling at everything. I have so much shit. Ooh, flint, nice. And I can't use half of it. Like, I don't need all of these stitching kits. I have a million stitching kits. I feel like I have a fucking... Fuck hell. Whatever, I'm taking all the stitching kits. Fuck hell. Snake. Wild garlic. It's hard to say no to food. Any food, it's hard to say no to. Did I miss the stand-up timer? God. Sorn it. First of all, it is 12:30 in the a.m. So my stand-up timer is going to be standing up to go to bed. It is late as shit. And he's, look at this bitty. Whoa. Alright, it is late as shit. Yes, I missed my stand-up timer. So instead of standing up, I will thank our subscribers. I had no idea. This is how you know when I'm really into a game, because I lose all... Oh, God. And I didn't, Beefcake, I didn't have much watch. I didn't have much watch around. I'm so sorry. What's the thing that I type into the chat? Does anyone remember? Usually Rich tells me. What do I type in the chat that gives me a list of all the people that subscribed? What do I say? There's like something I have to type in. Type in hashtag JackFail. I know. Exclamation point subs. Thank you. Ay, ay, ay. Will I play more of this game on Wednesday? I don't know. I cannot tell you for sure. You know me, I like to play new games. So I cannot tell you for sure. Okay, let's see who we have here today. We have Rich Evans is God. Lee Lewis Linden. Frevens. Genghis Borgnine. For 19 months in a row. Leftover Beefcake for 19 months in a row. John Kilo, 25 fucking months in a row. Solo 56.7. Mr. Bibbs, welcome to the 1 year club at 12 months in a row. The Real Vayan. Bad Gamer Korean. Ali Raza. Errant Pacifist. 25 months in Peru. Where were we? Errant Pacifist. Jerkwad Live. I like that. This new subscriber, Crispy Friedman. The Real Netboy. Murat Velmaz. That almost sounds like a name backwards. Murat Velmaz. Unpowerful Raindrop for 20 fucking months in a row. Godfather 42. 17 months in a row. Dr. Gunter Hunter Hanter. Nope. Dr. Gunter Hunter Hanker. How do you even... It's too late. Dr. Gunter Hunter Hanker. And I am got. Thank you all for subscribing. Thanks everyone for coming out tonight. I know these are a little more low-key and not as entertaining as the regular stream, but I appreciate you guys coming out anyway, and I will see you on Wednesday. Have a good night, all.